So you guys left the White Tower, the Ivory Tower, and headed to Crowmill. Found out that everybody was starving and dying. So you packed up pretty much everybody, aside from, I think, two, and left south to Aredell. Along the way, you met up with some friendly fellows named the Black Sons, who you got a little tiff with, and ended up killing all of them but two. One who's currently dying from a stomach wound, and the other guy who really likes to talk a lot, but it might have been because you guys hit him in the back of the head with a shield.
No.
So you guys arrived at Aredell, and you're essentially outside the city gates right now. That's kind of where we left off, with a good solid 60-ish people sitting with you. Yeah. So you're outside the gates. There's a few concerned-looking guards standing in front of the gates. But as I described previously, there's a big flood of people kind of going in and out of the city. Like, there's a big, big amount of traffic right now coming in. But people have noticed you, and they're kind of giving you a little bit of the squint eye right now, wondering why you're here with 60-odd clearly-looking refugees.
So we're at the gates, or are we, like, just coming up to it?
You're coming up to it, yeah.
Oh, okay. So I guess I'll wave to these people.
Okay. Release the arrows!
Yeah.
No!
Not again!
Welcome Why? To Aredell.
Yeah, they come from the north. Kill them on sight.
Maybe, actually, before we go up here, maybe Elias should do the talking, because I don't know if these guys remember our faces. So there was quite the incidents last time we were here. We kind of destroyed the portcullis with a cart and stole some stuff and burnt an inn down.
That's exciting. I think we should just try and get in and blend in with the 60 disguises we brought with us.
Yeah, actually, yeah, good idea. Yeah,
should be blended with
John Tane should do the talking then.
Let's bring no attention to our already massive group.
Yeah. Okay. Bear with me a moment here.
Can you refresh my memory, Alex? I know I went to the Coward's Tear last time I was here. Did we burn that one down, or was it a different inn?
It was a different inn.
Okay, good.
Oh, that's right. Man, we really...
See, have started lighting a few fires.
Yeah.
There's a reason I want this team, Bree'ek.
Why did you guys burn the inn down?
So I'm going to explain
this to you. We
were
getting attacked. We looted the place. It seemed like the best thing to do at the time.
Yeah, we came here and well, Antimus lit somebody on fire when we went to go eat some food.
Accidentally on purpose.
He was trying to poison us, to be fair, but we didn't know that.
Apparently something about some poison alcohol. What a waste.
So Alias...
We shouldn't mention that because... Yeah. There might have been people.
A lot
here
of shit happened.
Indeed, it did.
It was a rough couple of days.
Well, that was the one day. Yeah, that was. I think that was breakfast. Pretty sure it was just breakfast.
We really worked up an appetite, so we had to go for lunch, and then a whole other thing started.
That's when we got the second inn on fire.
Okay, sorry, bear with me here, guys. I have somehow lost several pages.
It's all good. Yeah, so we set that guy on fire. That was actually, he was working a rotisserie meat or something like that. And Antimus threw an oil flask at him, lighting him on fire, because he was right in front of the fire. I believe I puked in the fire, too.
But, like I said, they were asking for it. Well, the one guy's probably innocent, but I said, well.
Yeah. And, I don't know what happened to the other guy that tried to poison us. I think the guards chased him or something.
I was pretty close drinking that too. Like, if it wasn't for Antimaeus, I would. Yeah. Like, oh, wonderful, free. Oh, thank you. Sure. This is such a friendly city.
And then there was a festival, and then a bunch of people were getting stabbed at the festival, and then we ran into
the
Hide.
Yeah, and there's people shooting some crossbolts at us, too.
Yeah.
When we hit terrorists. So why are they letting all these people into the city still?
That sounds like a fantastic festival.
Shut the borders down. There
we go. It was horrible.
All right. Sorry about that. Yeah, so as you guys are kind of standing there debating what to do, Bryce peps up and is like, shit. Hey guys, I think I know how we can get in. We just need to disguise ourselves as a bunch of poor people. Oh, shouldn't be too hard. And he kind of like laughs at himself a little bit and he's like,
You were looking for that?
No.
I took you that long.
I swear if I was looking for that, you guys can fire me. No. So, yes. You guys are
should we just have one
gate.
Other guy?
Well, there was one guy that was, like, gutted, and I was healing him, testing my magic.
Yeah, that was it, right? We only had the two of them?
Yeah.
Yep, there was one that was alive for a little bit, and then he got a rapier through the throat.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Corey.
Because we knew he was lying.
Mm-hmm.
How did the other guy do in the few days after the incident? Because Pi was doing surgery on him.
Yeah, he's as fine as can be. He hasn't had a whole lot of conscious moments even after the experimentation of healing was done upon him. But yeah, he looks like he's gonna make it.
We burnt the thing off of him too, or
yes.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Yeah, you guys roasted both their necks.
Perfect.
Wow. What if he wants to remain?
He doesn't have a choice.
Let's begin the cleansing.
Hey, there's an idea of what we can do.
just on that note, is there anything as a group we should talk about before we enter into the city? Like any plans that we need to make? Just for if you don't mind, Alex, if we
no,
kind of collect ourselves before going in?
Please do.
Just because I'm sure all the city people are going to recognize us, and we're going to
say just try and keep a low profile.
Unless they drank all that wine that Antimaeus left them as a gift.
Yeah.
Antimaeus
is confident that we're pretty covered.
Because
mm-hmm. They weren't even, like last time I was here, they weren't even searching for me by like, you know, portrait on the wall type thing. It was just like, look for a shady guy. Right.
Okay.
So I think as a group, I think we're okay. But do we have to do anything about the gutted guy to see if, you know, if someone recognizes him or, you know, we can't really like tie him down.
I don't know. Well, I mean, he's unconscious most of the time. I mean, he's not going to say too much.
Just leave him in an alley somewhere because... I know Almagar is like, why? Yeah, the one guy seemed cool, but
it's kind of like back in the day, you force people into the army. It's just how it goes, Almagar. Like you're drafted, buddy.
Welcome to the
this
squad.
This is Pythagoras' army. This is how we do. You're now a hero. Congratulations.
High heroes. Hero Pie. No. We do have to come up with a group name, though.
Yeah. I think that's going to be required. If I know anything about Alex, I think some kind of mercenary group name or charter of something is going to need to be signed. Well, yeah. So.
What town did we tell them we were the Unyielding in?
That was Cromill. Yeah, Xena or Mabel, whatever, said... we were the Unyielding at one point. I don't know.
I think that's pretty snazzy.
Yeah? Okay.
So then we can't yield from now on. Sometimes you just have no one to walk away.
Sometimes.
Said no barbarian.
Elmagar, sometimes it's a longer focus. You know, you're temporarily walking away, you know.
Oh, I thought this was out of game. but no, should we offer our services like mercenaries? I'm sure they will need soldiers. And when I look at the map, our city versus the city in the east, this one is nicer and looks like it has more trees nearby, where the other one's more desert-like, so...
Yeah, but
that should be reason enough to...
They ravaged the city before we left, too, right? Like, at the festival?
Oh, that was them. That makes sense.
They, like, slaughtered I don't know how many people. Like, could we estimate, Alex?
Probably.
How many people died in that?
Yeah, probably a good, like, 50 or 60 at least.
Okay.
I'm assuming they targeted someone too, right? So they probably got some general or someone.
Just offering your service should keep us busy for a while then.
Well, it's up to Pi, because we do kind of owe the refugees protection if they wanted, I guess. But we did arm a few of them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, I'd like to help these people and get their trade route fixed if we can, and if not, I mean, they can grab all their supplies in the city if they can get in. If not, I'm sure they'll let in a few people, right? So John Tain can come in with a few of us or whatever, and we can grab some supplies, and he can take them out or bring a cart in with them too, take it out, and they can bring all their stuff back to their city, and they're good to go. They have all these weapons and like they're armed now, right? So, and if we want, we can go back there and deal with some issues in that fucking forest, like that the goddamn spiders
and the goblins.
The goblins, the wolves.
The green guys.
Yeah.
We're gonna take over Bree'ek. It'll be a goblin town.
Yeah.
So I guess we can wait on that decision, but like are we gonna lean that way? Because I like out of game I don't think the group would be as like we haven't really been leaning towards a mercenary group so much, but
yeah,
you know, I'm game anyway, like that's fine with me, but just so that we have like a group focus when we go into the RP side of things, we're not all like
and we just need somewhere for the winter, right? I mean, that's pretty much why we're here, at least.
Yeah, okay. I basically just wanted to help these people out, get their shit figured out so they can go back and be fed, right? We can, yeah. And while we're here, I mean, it's a big city. We can actually do our own shopping, right? Get some provisions, get some whatever we need, healer's kits, blankets, and stock up for winter, and you know all that stuff. So,
okay,
and figure out what's going on here too.
Let's get in the city then,
because we'll need a place to lodge, obviously, long term.
Yeah,
I know a place. It might be partially burnt out, but
oh, there we go. Have the villagers help us rebuild it, and then... Do you think the villagers will be able to go back if they get all their supplies, or is it going to be too wet, like, too far into winter by then?
It's only been, like, 2 weeks, I think, right? So...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, snow is falling at this point. And, like I said, when you guys were coming here, it's at the point where, you know, it's a few inches of it on the ground. It's getting cold.
Yeah, so they should be fine. Yeah, so John Tain, do you wanna do the honors? Go up and introduce yourself and why you guys are here.
Sure. Let's see, steps forward and kinda looks back at everyone and looks at you guys and walks up to the guard. And the guards are having a conversation, and
I'll walk with him, Alex. Okay. Just kind of like pretending to be his like personal guard, almost.
Okay. All right. Can you give me an intimidation check, please?
Sure.
Thank you.
That's 16.
What you're going to immediately notice is the guard that is standing at the gates is not equipped as the guards were previously. While they were not, you know, perfectly uniform, perhaps, they did wear similar clothing. They wore symbols of the city and so on and so forth. This guy does not, nor does the guy on the other side of the gate. In fact, this guy looks like he's more of kind of an experienced, you know, bar fighter than he is a guard. And as Jontain approaches, he looks at him and just goes, "Yeah, I don't want any words from you. Just keep on in." And Jontain goes, no, sorry, I have questions, he says. "I don't answer questions. Not my job. Keep on moving." Jontain goes, "All of those people." And as soon as he mentions all of them, the guy kind of stops and walks up to him, and he's now paying attention to him. And he goes, "Oh, yeah. Yeah, those people are all with you." Jontain says, "Yes, we need shelter. We need a place to stay." And he goes, "Yeah, okay, so I'm assuming that you're all planning on settling down here because you don't look like you're much for the fighting or adventuring type, at least not most of you," as he kind of glances over at you there, man. And he goes, yes, we, I don't know how long we'd stay, but presumably at least until the end of the winter. The guy goes, "Well, anyone we find coming through here that looks refugee-like, there's a fee. So as long as you and your people are willing to pay it and are willing to come in and make yourselves your own homes without any expectations of handouts, then that should be absolutely fine." Jontain says, "Well, how much is the fee?" The guy says, a humble 5 gold pieces a person. So if you so wish to bring them in, feel free. I'll happily accept the payment myself. Make sure it gets the right people.
Can we
anyone
all
else paying this guy?
Can we all hear him?
I don't know. Only Antimaeus said he was going up. Sorry.
Oh, so okay. Yeah.
Like no one else is walking by and handing money.
No, but no one else looks like they're villagers. Everybody else coming in and out of here are either merchants, like clear merchants, or they are well armed people.
Take me to your leader.
Mercenary groups, other adventurers, so on and so forth. That said, they don't look like they're paying too close attention. Like
yeah.
the guards, yeah.
Yeah. I'll ask them to see the official government order.
He laughs again. Government order. There is no government order. We were told what to do. There is no real government here anymore.
And I'll wave the people forward. Head in.
Okay, so you're gonna motion with a group of people to start coming in.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll start walking to kind of get the pack moving, hopefully.
And then I'll pretend to be like fumbling with coin.
Okay. The guy immediately puts his hand out and says, "Whoa! I did not say they could come in. Are you deaf? You heard me. 5 gold pieces a person or your refugee camp doesn't come into the city. I've been given orders." And
let's
with that,
them.
He whistles. And several bowmen along the wall appear, pulling crossbows. And he says, "If they take another damn step forward, kill them all." And the villagers just all stop. "I don't need to present you with any orders. The temporary government in the city has told us what to do and what not to do. This is what we've been told to do. It's what we've been hired to do. I'm getting paid to do exactly what I'm telling you right now. So all of your friends here can die, or you can pay me 5 gold pieces a person, or you can sleep outside the damn city walls. Those are your 3 options.
I'll whistle to that lady, who I don't know her name is. I'll ask her to come forward.
The girl? Okay.
Yeah. I'll say, she can take the horse and go here, and I'll tell her the directions and tell them that I'm having a problem getting back into the city. And
okay.
So I'll send her out to the guild.
Oh, shit. Antimaeus has a guild!
Came back with friends.
All right.
And if they try to stop her, I'll say she's armed and she's an adventurer. Why would you stop her?
Yeah, they don't give her any grief as she walks in with the horse. She kind of gives you a strange look, but takes the horse and goes in the city.
Okay, and then I'll just say, okay, well, we'll wait to hear word from the city, and then we'll come back to talk to you.
All right.
Can I have your names, please?
Nope. You cannot.
Do you sleep nearby? And then I'll
sure
wink
do.
And walk away.
All right. He just walks back to the wall, starts looking at people as nonchalantly as he was before, waving a few in, questioning the occasional person, but not often and not many.
I'll go back to Pythagoras and explain what happened.
Well,
and then I'll say I'll try to get the guild to put pressure on them to let us in, but it might not work.
You're part of a guild?
Loosely, yeah.
Are you guys well acquainted, or like...
Acquainted enough, but I don't have much pull. But if the government's fallen and it's a temporary government, I'm sure they'll be happy to get any foothold. Oh. I.e., if they have to kill everyone and take over the gate, then I'm sure they wouldn't be too upset about having control.
Good thinking.
Is your guild the Black Suns, by any chance? No.
No.
Obviously,
they don't like the Black Suns very much.
All right, so I guess we'll wait for your contacts. See what happens there.
I don't have enough money to pay for all these people.
No, obviously. That's like what? Like 900 gold or something? 1,000 gold? I don't know, I'm bad at math.
Yeah, well, either way, yeah, we're obviously not paying, but...
Do we have looks anyone like, else that is in the city?
Looks like the city needs us to become the new government.
Well, maybe we just change plans and just go in, buy supplies, and leave.
That's true too. Yeah, like, I do have some gold. Like,
yeah, and if they're charging this much at the gate, I guarantee you food's going to be too expensive for us to sustain them through the winter.
Yeah,
I'm thinking too. Depending on this new temporary government, they might be, I don't know, more willing if they know they're from Bree'ek, right? I know these people aren't, obviously if they're trading back and forth, it's not that. At least we probably know why the shipment stopped.
Yeah, I guess your contract is, or whatever, is null there, John Tane.
Looks like. I wonder if the merchants that you should trade with us are still among the living.
What do you want to do?
I don't rightly know, to be honest. I've never really been in a situation like this before. But I'll tell you one thing. These people aren't going to live outside these walls for too long. So I don't think that's really an option.
Well, maybe just a few of us can go in and... I mean, get you your food and you can head back to Bree'ek if you want. We can come back with you if you need to.
All right. Yeah, okay. How long are you guys waiting for?
What time of day is it?
You guys arrived about midday.
I think we can just eat, like, we can give everyone full rations and eat and wait about an hour.
Okay. After an hour, no one's arrived.
Oh, shit.
Shortly after, though, the young girl does come back through the gate with your horse.
I'll head up to her, yeah.
Okay, she comes up to you and says, I made contact with them. They didn't really tell me much, but they said, you know, they've heard me, is what they told me.
Perfect. Okay, for the time being, I think we should do exactly that. Pythagoras, I think let's go and see if we can secure, see how much we could secure. Not necessarily that we have the money change hands, but let's see if there's even enough supplies, right? Like,
yeah, exactly.
If you go and they're like, oh, a month rations, like, you know, you're 20 gold or whatever, like.
Right, yeah.
If they're unreasonable, then we just need to know that.
These people aren't going to live going all the way back to Bree'ek now, right? Because they barely made it here.
They need winter supplies. Mm-hmm. And so buying that, I am assuming, is going to be an arm and a leg, so.
John Tane, do you have the coin to get all these supplies for your people?
Collectively, we probably have, he looks back, I don't know. I personally have a silver piece on me. How expensive is stuff in the city? We don't trade for money. We trade for good for goods, right? We don't really have any use for...
Right, right.
Hence, we have elk pelts and rabbit feet and, like, some stuff like that.
Is that what you usually
and
trade with?
And we do have a card of weapons.
Do you trade with, like, pelts and stuff like that, or typically, like...
Sometimes, yeah. Okay. We trade kind of whatever we can gather. Our main thing was wood. We were more so a lumber type of place, but I'm sure they would trade anything.
And we got a cart of weapons.
So how much do you think you and your people would need to last the winter, basically?
Well, winter's in the north. As you know, we're about, you know, sometimes 4 months long, 4 or 5 months long. So we need to figure out something certain that. I can't expect you guys to keep us fed that entire time. To be honest, I was kind of hoping that they'd let us into this city so that we can figure things out.
So 4 or 5 months, you need some livestock.
I'll be right back. I'm going to go talk to the guard that Antimaeus talked to.
Okay. All right. He sees you approaching, gives you kind of a side glance, and just says, "Keep on moving."
Who's this temporary government I hear about? This temporary,
I don't completely know. All I know is the nobles are fighting over who owns this city right now. Somebody died. That's all I know.
Was it the previous, I guess, mayor or something of this city that died?
The Lord of Aredell, I guess, is what he was called. Yeah, he died. Some party thing. I heard a bunch of people got stabbed to death. Nasty business. You know, sometimes I wonder. I was offered a job earlier that day for some pretty good coin, but I was busy, so I turned it down. Maybe I would have been the one who killed the guy.
Oh, smart man.
Well, suppose the way you look at it.
Or lucky, who knows? Huh.
But anyways, you got to keep on moving into the town. What can I do for you otherwise? I got, you know, got to look after all these people, so.
Where would I find these nobles that are warring? Are they, they're both in the city?
Oh yeah, all of them, yeah. Yeah, they're all in the city, living in their villas, all over the place.
Do you know where they're located at all?
No.
No?
Sorry. Okay. I haven't really been in the city much. I came from some of the southern areas up here for work, and work I found.
Does he have, like, a tattoo on his neck? No.
No? Okay. No. He does look pretty beaten and bruised, though. He's got kind of a bushy, unkept beard. It's got quite a bit of gray in it. Yeah. Big guy.
You don't look too good yourself. It looks like you haven't eaten as well as most people. I mean, look at these people. They haven't eaten very well as well. I think you can understand that. Is there any way you can maybe just let them come on through?
You want to give me a persuasion?
No.
Charisma.
Couldn't somebody else be... Yeah.
At least I don't have disadvantage.
I was just going to say that.
You must still have a little bit of charisma.
All right, first roll of the night. And it'll be a one. Persuasion. I don't have that, so just charisma. And it's a one. It's actually a one.
It's actually a one.
I'm not even fucking with you.
And it begins.
He looks at you and goes, oh yeah, I understand. You're with those people. Okay, yeah. No, I completely understand what it's like not to eat. And since you're, you know, calling me gaunt or skinny or appearing to be poor, I take it that you must be quite much better off than I am. So I'm sure, you know, the 5 gold pieces per person that I told your last friend, that's actually going to go up to 6 now. The extra gold per person is just for me. We'll be fine to somebody who has eaten so well. Now get out of my freaking face before I kill you and everyone you're with.
And with that, I will shrug my shoulders and walk away in shame.
Oh, don't worry, we'll end up killing him.
He'll be dead by sundown.
Or we could just, yeah.
They'll go up to him and be like, him, he's marked. Well, shit. Fuck. Well, they're letting us in. The people that are armed in, anyway.
Yeah, well, we need to go in and see what we can do. And we can't, because we can't leave them out here very long.
Well, maybe this is stupid, but maybe we should just try sending in a few at a time. Like, staggered. You know what I mean? Because they're letting other people in.
Mm-hmm.
So, especially if they don't see a group of 60 walking through, like,
yeah,
we have how many with weapons? We have 12, correct me if I'm wrong, 12, was it?
There was more than that. I think I got, like, 22 or something like that.
Well, it was the number of, no, it was 10. Minus 2, so it had been 8, unless we gave the weapons of the other two, right? Because wasn't there 10 guys that we fought?
Well, we got a cart of weapons, too.
Their cart was full of weapons.
Yeah, and we had other weapons on us, too, that we gave to the villagers as well.
So
there's a whole bunch of them that got armed.
My suggestion is send 5 at a time, staggered, and just, like, walk in.
Yeah, let's try that. Yeah. You know, what else are we going to do?
Right? Like, send a couple weapon guys together and then have 3 or 4 other people carrying stuff behind them, right? Like, who are they to say that they're not, you know, servants of these guys with weapons? I don't know.
Yeah. Okay. So, yeah, maybe I'll go in with 5 people by myself and then, yeah, do what you said there. That's great.
All right. Yeah, that. All right, so you accompany 5 people in. Hi. As you walk through the gates, the guy who gave you a hard time there points at you and says, that better be everyone you're bringing in. If I start seeing more of those stragglers creeping in through these gates, you're dead. Have a nice day.
Yeah. Fuck you. And I walk in.
All right, but yeah, they let you pass through. No problem. So as soon as you're through, the street gets a little less busy after you're directly away from the gate. It's kind of like a big pool of people there. Most of the kind of backup seems to be the fact that a ton of people are stopped and are like talking to each other right at the entrance of the gate. And normally this would be kind of a typical guard's job to disperse people, you know, keep traffic flow moving, but this isn't happening. Most of the guards are playing dice or have some kind of drinks out in the open, and they all look very much like that other guy. They're wearing kind of raggedy armor. Some are better equipped than others, but not by much. And most of them have far more weapons than a typical guard does. And they give like kind of side glances to some of the people walking through, but for the most part, they're really not paying a whole lot of attention. But after you break through a little bit of the crowd, the street opens up. It's still busy, but it's not nearly quite as bad as the entrance. And, yeah, there you are in Aredell.
Is this the town square where we burnt the inn down?
No, not quite yet. This is just kind of the main entrance road, but you could definitely go there if you so wish.
I'd like to actually just kind of overhear some conversations, see what people are saying right now. Like the guards and, you know, regular town folk and stuff like that.
Sure. Do you want to give me just a perception?
Sure. Let's not roll a one. That's kind of better. 12.
Okay. Yeah, there's quite a lot of talk around you. Most of it is to do with trade, but you do hear a few disgruntled people as well barking about how I came all this bloody way in the middle of damn winter just to find there's no more work here. And then some other little guy just kind of says, well, there was the no! I'm not taking jobs from crazy old coots who can't pay me up front. There is no way. This damn town I was lied to! And he kind of walks away. And you hear a few common sentiments from some of the more well-equipped people that they've clearly come here looking for work, and not everyone's finding it. On the opposite spectrum, though, you hear a few people, you know, joking around about how they can't believe they got paid that much to do that type of work, and so on and so forth. So there's a bit of sentiments of both.
Interesting. Have they dropped any names, like maybe the nobles or something like that?
No real talk about the nobles, no. But you do hear a few names of inns get mentioned. That they visited and or are going to visit, if you care.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So you hear three inns mentioned. So there's the Golden Librum, Harith's Barrel, and the Shining Flute.
Oh, I like that. Shining Flute.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, I'm just going to wait for everybody else to come in now, basically.
Okay. All right, so you guys are going to funnel these people in little group by little group. How are you approaching that?
Just send a few, like, because if we have, I don't know how many people with weapons, just send... How many people with weapons? Because there's 60 of us in total, right? Pi got 5 in, so there's 55.
Yeah.
So if we have, what, like 20 people with weapons, just send one person with weapons and two without at a time in different
groups. Or we come back out, we can sneak one ship weapons back out.
There we go.
And I'll stay out because he knows who I am.
Okay.
Myself, whoever I'm taking through, I'll just be basically talking, like telling, you know, stories about the last fight we got into. And
sure.
Just kind of
really bolstering the whole "I get out there and kill people" kind of.
Yeah, and like I said, I've got my great axe, so I'll give my hand axes out so they can put them on, you know, maybe your belt or something, so it looks, sure, you know, it looks a little more.
All right. Yeah, you make it through absolutely fine, and over the course of the next couple hours, the rest of the villagers make it through completely fine as well, using this strategy. You know, one person holding a weapon among
I'm gonna state I'm gonna be driving that cart with the weapons. I'm sticking near that.
Yeah, good idea.
All right. And you're just going with the cart and the weapons, no other people?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, they don't seem to bother you coming through either. They clearly think that you're there for some kind of a reason, probably to get coin or whatever, so they don't seem to bug you too much. But yeah, you make it through everybody else. Apparently they didn't really see too much of a threat of one person going in with a couple. You do see, Jordan, you see the guy with the big gray beard who gave you some hassle. Kind of look over to where the big group of them were that's no longer there. Yeah, she lets like a kind of a chuckle, almost like he thinks that you guys probably all left and he won. But yeah, so that is where you guys are at currently.
Okay. Well, let's go get you some supplies, John Tane.
All right. What should I tell the rest of the villagers that have managed to sneak in? Like, where should they go? Mm-hmm. It's probably not a good idea for them to all be grouped up.
I'll mention the conversations that I overheard to the group. Drop the inn names. I don't know if those inns might be actually a good place to stay. I don't know if it's
okay.
If there's room.
Yeah. All right.
If they can afford it.
Yeah, that's my only concern. I don't know how much an inn and that sort of thing costs, but I can send a few people there. Walk around, but if we at least designate those maybe meeting points out front of those three places, the people will be dispersed enough, and you know they can otherwise just walk the city kind of thing. So maybe I'll tell them to meet at one of those three locations at kind of sundown.
Okay.
Hopefully, we'll have some answers then. If that works for you guys.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Okay. Yeah. So he goes off and has a conversation with a few different people. And they all seem to nod and understand, and they all part ways. Most of them take their weapons with them. A few drop in the cart, unless you guys want to request those weapons back from them, of course.
Oh, yeah, I'll definitely get my hand axes back for sure.
Sure, okay. But how about the
cart? They're silver.
Yeah, good point, yeah.
I don't know.
And
we can keep them.
And I'll eventually make it into the city, Alex, as long as there's no issues.
None whatsoever.
Okay. So I'll whisper to the group so that like not everyone hears, but I'm assuming we're gonna sell these weapons in exchange for food anyway, so
yeah, that's the plan.
Just before everyone disperses, maybe we mention that to them. And then with every group, maybe send one or two people instead of the whole group, right? Like send one or two people with weapons to kind of fend off any potential issues.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Okay. All right. So you're sending a few people away with weapons, but that's about it.
So do you guys want to investigate one of these inns? See what's going on. Sounds like people are getting some jobs here, maybe.
I assume we're probably going to eventually want to head up, you know, find some more about the nobles, figure out which ones we think should be.
Try and make some friends?
Yeah, see, we'd be better off leaving these people, because obviously a city this size can't be just run by, you know, they actually have to have some kind of system in place.
Yeah, maybe we'll go to the inn and ask around one of these inns. Or we could always split up too. I mean, we're in a city, it's fine. We're not in a dungeon with a hentai monster, so.
We could kind of just pair off and
a cart of weapons.
What's that?
So in the meantime, what are we going to do with a cart full of weapons?
Right.
Maybe we should hold on to those for now, just until, again, say if there's one noble family or something that seems like they'd be the better ones to lead, we can. Maybe they could, you know.
Well,
I don't know.
Before we get too entangled in political issues, maybe we should decide on whether we're going to send these villagers back with supplies or whether we're going to try to find them a permanent or semi-permanent situation here.
True. If we can use the weapons to barter for supplies, then
we will not be able to house 60 people even for a night in an inn.
Yeah, true.
Like, not to be devil's advocate, but
yeah, no, it makes sense. Yeah, even a barn for the night is. But yeah, maybe we should. Yeah, maybe if some of us want to go try listening at the inn and. help Maple or whoever wants to go with the cart and see about trading for supplies and whatnot.
Well, we could just all go and trade and then all go to the inn, I think.
Okay.
Just to keep everyone together, right? Like,
right.
Yeah.
We don't need to split up.
Mm-hmm. True.
Especially since there are people out here looking for us.
Yeah, that's right. Last thing we need to split up and...
Well, I think we all have, like, 2-month-old beards. I think we're fine.
Speak for yourselves.
You're a barbarian. Didn't Alex like, tell you?
Yeah, Maple, you might want to, you know...
I'm not a werewolf.
Got a under your nose.
Not a werewolf. That was Nexus.
Oh?
You don't remember that?
Oh, I don't think I remember that part.
Alex, would we know, or would I know, like, what district would be known for trading in kind of like foodstuffs and, you know, winter supplies, for lack of a better term?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you definitely know. There's a fairly large market in Aredell, and there is a section there specifically for that type of trade. So,
yeah.
I'll bet you some of these merchants will have some more information, too.
Yeah, and that's kind of my feeling as well. Is let's like it's up to Pi whether he wants to be the leader of these people permanently or not. But
no,
I'm
so hungry and tired.
I think morally, Antimus is leading off of the moral obligation. I don't think Pi's at the point where he can just be like, "Got a job, see you guys."
Yeah,
but that's your call. So I'm kind of leaning towards going to the market. Let's see if we can. You know, see if we can get the supplies. If we can get the supplies for the weapons, great. You know, we turn around and say, off you go. Good luck.
Yeah, that would be the best option. I mean, it, like you said, it'd be hard to get rooms for 60 people in several inns. Like, I guess there's 3 here, 4 or 5 inns.
Like, I'm sure a few of them might be able to find work, and that's great, but yeah.
Yeah, but look at the city.
But
now.
Exactly.
It's over,
right now, yeah. There's not enough for 60 people.
It's full capacity, like, right now. So.
They're better off getting the supplies and traveling back before it's, you know, too much into winter.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we exhaust plan A, which is sending them back. And then if we can't send them back, then we exhaust plan B, which is finding a place and finding them work and or setting them up. We don't have to find the work, right? Like, it's up to them to kind of fend for themselves within reason. But
I'm sure the Black Suns could use some new members.
Yeah, well.
Yeah.
Or mercenaries.
Who likes tattoos?
opening. Antimus isn't too worried about, like, skilled, knowing the city and stuff like that. Like, obviously there's a flood of people in here, but at the same time, if it's a flood of people preparing for war and warriors, then you still need carpenters, you still need, you know, tailors, you still need all these other professions, which is what the villagers are, right? So... I think we'll be okay if we get stuck, but I think that's a conversation after we try to hawk these weapons for supplies.
Cool, cool.
That's my personal feeling anyway.
So yeah, let's go and
then
do that then.
And then we go kill that guard.
Yeah. He's Antimaeus marked, so.
Yeah, we have a reputation to hold.
Got to crunch some numbers there, accountant.
Yeah. Well, I honestly, the first thing I was thinking was like, I could put a hit on him. I wonder how much that would cost.
That's awesome.
Because then it's not me against Alex. It's just me using Alex's campaign to, you know.
Hey, it's never me against you, man. I'm on your side. I hate that guy. I kill him.
All right, so let's definitely do that then. Antimaeus, you know the city really well, so
yeah, and because I know the city, I can lead you there really fast. Thank you, background skill.
All right, so you guys go to trade the goods then. So what exactly are you, like, I know you're looking for supplies to get these people back to Bree'ek, okay, but are you looking just for, like, an equivalent, you know, here's a 10 days worth of supplies, congrats, we'll have fun back in Bree'ek again, or are you looking for supplies to, like, maintain them for months, or What are you looking for?
They need livestock. They gotta be able to maintain for months. So we need to get a little bit, like a couple chickens and like a goat or something.
Or just get the trade going again. Convince some of these merchants to bring supplies up there.
Yeah, but maybe if we can find that contract. But now we got a cart of weapons we need to get rid of.
Let's talk to the would-be mayor. Who's the would-be mayor again? John Tane?
John Tane, yeah.
John Tane, do you trade in wintertime?
No, not really.
Can you?
I suppose the words could leave my mouth if that's what you're asking.
I'm saying, John Tane, it is more reasonable for us to get you a couple months' supplies so that you guys can get some timber cut and send it to the city than it is for us to get you 4 months' supplies and say, just hold out.
I understand what you're saying. Okay.
When we're having these conversations, we need to know what you guys need to make it through winter.
Well, if we weren't all occupied on trying to feed ourselves, wood can be cut at any time of the year, right? It might be.
But can you get it to market?
Well, the biggest place where we used to trade wood was Aelioth, and that's because they have so many ships that dock there. So there's kind of a big market for wood there. With the state of Aredell, I don't know, maybe it'd be better if we did go up north and try to trade with them there. So yeah, we could try it.
Yeah, but you don't have any horses.
We don't.
How's Necromancer?
Yeah, how is Necromancer?
Oh, it's a good sign.
Well, you were sneaking into the gates. She had no idea.
Yeah, the guard's just like, that cannot come in.
Whatever this is.
Last thing we need is another dead animal carcass laying around this back alley.
Yeah, because we could use, on a side note, pulling from Maple's situation, we could use horses to pull sleds carrying lumber, right? In the
you
snow.
Should be, yeah, I don't think the villagers can
technically
make sleds.
Technically the villagers wouldn't even need horses if they had sleds. We could find, like, a
caribou.
Cheaper method. Like,
I can't think of any other way, but if you can, that's...
Yeah, maybe three
otherwise,
barbarians.
I think we're stuck looking for 4 months of food, which I know that number is going to be awesome. Yeah. And we want it delivered monthly. Anyone, any ideas before Alex, like, totally laughs at us with an NPC?
We all know it's coming.
Oh, yeah. The livestock 50, idea was really
does
good.
50 well, gold do for 4 months' supplies?
Well, I'm thinking of it like this. A couple chickens, so, you know, you need a little bit of feed. And if they can keep that one was saying, they could always go back and get more supplies and replenish. So we don't need, you know, 4 months of trade goods. So if they had like a few chickens or something, they got eggs, and if it does die, well, then they can cook it. But, you know, a goat, you get some milk, and
yeah, that's a really good
idea.
You
know, like it's cheaper than buying a.
Probably need a few dozen chickens.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Depending on how many people decide to go back to the city, depending on, you know, if people do find work here, you know, they're. Just a little bit at a time, enough to get them by, so as they can build up their contracts again. It's something. Mm-hmm. I mean, we don't have enough to supply them for 4 months. 4 to 6 months, depending on how the winter it goes.
Judging from what we know, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, Alex, and obviously there's changes, but I'm just going to go with the PHP so we have context. Living expenses for Wretched is zero, because obviously you're living on, like, grass.
Been there!
And then the next highest is 1 silver piece per day times 60. So 60 silver pieces per day, and then 4 months. So, yeah. And then you account for war inflation.
So a gold piece a day.
Yeah. So I think you're along the right track, Maple. I think like if we could get him a couple of draft horses, like give him the one we have and then another one.
Yeah, just get him a few basic supplies to get them going.
Get them a month, or yeah, like a couple of weeks. Well, actually, you'd have to have a month. You'd have to have a month because the horses are going to have to pull the lumber to towns or wherever they're pulling it, and you could have two wagons with one horse each, right, or whatever it is.
Donkeys are cheap. Can I look at Necromancer?
Yeah, but it's not going to be able to pull lumber. It could do well for smaller supplies and goods. That's why I suggested getting a goat, because then they can still at least get a little bit of work out of it, but and get milk.
60 villagers, what would that equal in horsepower?
Yeah, and in the end, I think it's up to them. So I think we just see what we can get for the weapons and see what we can give them a head start with. Because, you know, we could just present them with the option, right? Like,
anyway. Well, right now we're on a cart. We don't have to sell the cart. We can just sell the weapons on it. So there's one up.
I think we have a wagon. Or is it a cart?
It's a cart.
It says a cart of weapons.
Anyway, maybe we're just over talking it. We just need to ask Alex's NPC if he wants all these weapons.
Talk to no.
All that planning for nothing.
Yeah, exactly.
And okay, who's the most charismatic in the group? Like,
well, absolutely me.
Figure this out.
Like, I don't mind talking, but I'm only like not the metagame, but Antimaeus is like better than average, and I'm not going to tell you my score. I'm just better than average.
I have 9 charisma, so I have a -1. I don't know why I'm leader. I seriously don't.
Because I'm hilarious.
You cleared it the day you arrived. Yeah. Very charismatic.
But if anyone else feels like competent doing the talking besides myself or Pythagoras, then perhaps the barbarians. So
I don't have any negative, but I don't get any bonuses.
How you doing, buddy?
I do have a bonus to my charisma. I'm not gonna lie. Trade is actually one of my specialties, considering that is what I grew up doing with my family.
Trading fists.
So stereotypical. Oh,
barbarian insult.
Yeah. She's like, well, yeah. Is there any other kind of trade?
That just happens.
Fists for food. It works.
Anyway, so I suggest perhaps we have someone that's actually skilled. So if you want to take that, Maple, go for it.
That sounds good.
Yeah, didn't you say you traded with dwarves or something?
Dwarves and gnomes in the area when they came through.
I just realized I know nothing about you. We're going to talk later.
Are you? Yeah. Maybe we should communicate more. Maybe I'd do some team building exercises.
Shut the fuck up, Almgar.
You should come hunting one day.
I heard about this retreat, this place called like Faerun or something. I don't know. We should go there.
On a side note, Alex, I'll invite the girl to come with us too, if she wants to.
Okay.
And then I'll lead the group towards the trade goods area.
Who's this girl? Sorry, I don't remember.
Yeah, she's just some chick that Antimaeus has been hanging around with.
Oh, okay.
She's having me waiting at the door when we arrived.
I'm giving you the nod, just kind of like, good on ya.
Yeah, buddy. One of the girls from Bree'ek that actually ended up taking a weapon. Yeah. So she's just here with you guys, looking around.
That was too Beth-like.
Aw, she's perfect for Antimaeus. She's so shifty.
Beth's a little more direct. She's a lot more screaming.
Yeah, that's true.
All right, so you guys are going to go to the market. You're going to go see what you can get for these weapons then. That's the consensus.
Yes.
Are you primarily looking for people who are trading livestock? Is that also the consensus?
We should ask John Tane if that's feasible for him and his villagers, or if they're just going to turn around and eat all the livestock on us again.
Chickens! Oh,
have a feast tonight!
36 chickens later. They're full for a couple days.
Oh, he's definitely Jonathan's brother.
No, John Tane will say, well, I mean, you know, we definitely... manage to self-sustain ourselves. Well, I shouldn't say that. Most of the food we get is from trade, but it's not like we're stupid with animals either. You have to know a little bit about it when you're living out in the middle of a forest. So, while we weren't really prepared for what happened because we got raided, yeah, we can like deal with chickens and goats, that sort of thing, and they'd probably go a lot farther than just getting us food. So, yeah, probably not a bad plan.
I think we hit up just wheat and then chicken and goats.
Chicken and goats and wheat. All right.
Because that's like the cheapest stuff. Okay.
And that'll be the name of this episode: Chicken, Goats, and Wheat.
I'll trade you 4 stone.
Anyone got brick? I need brick. Okay, so you guys start walking on the market. There's not a whole lot. Oh, let me start over here. You walk in the market. What you're noticing is being traded a lot are goods that have anything to do with hurting other people and goods that have to do with feeding themselves. Not a whole lot of people going around looking for livestock, and you're going to notice that people are actually being turned away from blacksmiths and leather workers and all these types of people because they're throwing their hands up in the air and they'll be like, look, I can only make so many damn swords in a week and they're gone. Like, I'm sorry. And you have some like altercations and people getting angry about things and that sort of thing. So that's going on. And then as you're looking for livestock, as you're walking through these kind of situations, you see some poor chicken vendor.
My cabbages! Sitting over there in the corner, you know, scraggly, just over in the mud.
He looks like he's a farmer by trade that's probably come in from one of the exterior farms. So if you remember correctly, Aredell had farms kind of around it, sort of. They're not really in the northern side, but they did have some outlying farms. This guy looks like he's got a little cart behind him. And it looks like he's brought in like a few cages with chickens in them and that sort of thing. And he's got a couple of livestock as well, including goats and donkeys and a couple of horses. And there he is just with a chicken. And he's holding it in his hands while it's like flapping its wings as hard as it possibly can. And he's just going, chicken, chickens for sale, good chickens. Anyone who wants his chicken? And people are just kind of like looking at him and walking by. A couple people spit at his feet. He goes, ah, no one buys the chickens today.
Well, let's head over to that guy.
I have lovely goats. Ah, hello. He looks to the two barbarians and goes, you look like you know animals. Come here. Yes. I have chickens. I have goats. You have a cart. I can put them on the cart for exchange of minimal coin. I promise. Look at this one. Look at his wingspan. He grabs the wings. You see, they are healthy and very good.
Yeah, well, speaking of that, I would like to do a perception check on the chickens. And a separate one on the goats. Very detailed, because I want to actually make sure they're of good quality. That we're not getting something that's, like, disease-ridden and like, oh yeah, this is going to last you a few months.
Necromancer.
Hey, maybe I'll trade for Necromancer.
Oh, you have a sickly beast. It's gross.
Keep them away from my guts.
So 11 for the chickens and 11 for the goats.
I was supposed to start talking that accent. They look like they're in pretty good shape. I mean, a little terrorized from the guy, like, you know, stretching their wings and grabbing them. Like, the chickens are like, fuck, man. But they don't look unhealthy. They don't look like they're too physically abused. Yeah, they're in good state. And he looks at you, inspecting them, and he goes, I knew one of you would know a good beast when you see one. You give it a, smell. You smell good, like good livestock, hearty.
I smell right. Necromancer.
Roughly, how many chickens and goats does this guy have on him right now?
He's got like 6 chickens and 3 goats and 2 horses. And some bundles of like wheat and that sort of thing too. I like you. I like how you smell the animals before purchasing. I will give you a very good price.
I'll just kind of lean in and be like, well, what are we talking about here? What price?
I don't know. This is not how we start. You northerners are so strange. I don't know. 1 billion gold pieces. You tell me what you want to pay. This is how this works. A very fine goat. I call him Robert. good northern name, right?
Roughly, what estimate would I look at for all of this in total if I was to purchase the lot from you there? You know, northerner discount, I'm sure.
Oh, it is my lucky day. You do me a great honor. Oh, I do not know. Oh, he like twiddles his beard a little bit. Just to give you guys some context as to what this guy looks like. He's got quite dark hair. He almost looks like that dwarven woman that you met, but he's not short and stout. He's a pretty tall, lanky guy, you know, just under 6 feet. Very dark hair, tan skin, and he's got kind of like this beard that comes straight down, and then he's got this little braid.
Oh, he's got like wizard's comb.
Kind of like nice little bobbles sticking out of them, like little colors, that sort of thing. And cool. Yeah, and he's also got a big old ring in his nose as well. But yeah, so he goes, I do not know.
I like him. I think he should join our group. No.
Perhaps 15, 20 gold pieces? Somewhere in that range. I don't know. You have a cart? What are you carrying? Maybe we can barter a little bit. I know it's a steep price, but very good animals.
Well, I do have a few weapons here if you're interested in bartering.
Oh, you have one of the few people left with weapons to take, yeah. Oh, I could certainly barter for weapons. There is no shortage of people that need weapons here. I mean, you're not a good salesperson. You probably could not get good prices. You should give them to me. But, yes, I could trade. You know. Well, let's see. How many weapons do you have?
I'll shake my head at Maple.
You know. Got a few. I mean, what are you looking for?
Can I see some of them? Are they good quality? What are they? Are they swords or spears?
Oh, we got a lot of daggers.
Oh, daggers are
spears. Yeah, well, you know, they have a variety of sizes.
Ah, well, okay. Can I see one of them? At least to see a separate quality.
I'll whisper to Maple, I'll pay gold. We'll sell the weapons somewhere else.
15 gold for the lot.
Deal. But. Perhaps, you know, you buy the whole thing. How do you know this is all you need? I have a farm, not too far from Aredell. More livestock. Better, in fact. I could sell you more if you need more.
Well.
And to get you better price.
I'll kind of nod. It'd be this gentleman here you'd be selling for, and I'll do a head nod and kind of hope that Jontaine gets the idea and gets his ass up over here.
Yes. Hello. This... Yes. 15 gold pieces sounds. Kind of looks back at the rest of you. Good. Yes, that sounds wonderful. We may need more livestock, so looks back at you guys again. Perhaps we could go to the farm to see what else he has.
Could...
I'm gonna whisper to Pythagoras. This guy is a terrible leader.
I was just gonna say that. I was just gonna say that.
I'm sorry, I don't do it.
How about we put in pre-orders for a certain amount of chickens every few weeks? So like a month, and then you guys get like 5 chickens on delivery. You guys set up a bartering system.
That would be even better.
Yeah, sure. John T.
Do you travel for the north ever? And the man goes, this is already so far. No, I need to go back to the sun, to my home, to the sand. Ah. Well, how far do you want me to go? You know, I do not just give my services away, but I could be persuaded for the right price to go somewhere. Yes. Jontaine says, well, we're from a village called Bree'ek. The man says, like, do you know where Bree'ek? Ah, yes, I know Bree'ek. I'm not born of a day before today. Yes, I know where Bree'ek is located. It's a small, quaint place. I could be potentially persuaded to go there every couple of months for a nice premium, yes. This could be arranged. Perhaps for your weapons. Give you what I have here, and, you know, once more over of this, if you have a good amount of weapons, I'm not going to lie. I mean, if you just had one or two, you'd probably be carrying them on you, but you have a gun. I'm going to assume you have a good amount of weapons. So let us say this. If you have a good amount of weapons, let's just pretend you do. I have a good amount of faith that I can help you. You get these ones, okay, 15 gold pieces like we agreed. Plus, if you have enough weapons, monthly shipments to Bree'ek, I can do this.
Can I roll an insight to see if he's like trying to swindle?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, I'm not using that dice. Let's try this one.
I'll hand 15 gold pieces to Maple.
Nice. 23.
Okay. So, the guy isn't being dishonest, but he definitely wants the weapons more than he wants an exchange of gold. And it's probably because he knows he could sell them for a very, very good price.
I've got some cash on me. I say we just.
I've got gold on me too.
Yeah. So. Like, and I'll whisper this, Alex. I'll say, you know, we could go to a blacksmith that we've used a couple times when we were here, and we could get him to sell it for us for a cut, right, or something like that, where, you know, we know that the guy's going to have the best interest to get us the best price. And I don't, like, can I make an intelligence check to see if 15 gold for all this livestock that he has is a decent price?
Yeah, sure.
Nine, if it's just straight intelligence. Because, correct me if I'm wrong, it was a couple goats, 2 horses, and then, like, 6 chickens or something?
And feed for them.
Yeah. So, the guy is giving you an extremely fair price for this. Okay. The horses, while they're probably... They're definitely horses. They're not ponies. But they're smaller horses. So, I mean, they're not... So
they're not draft horses.
They're definitely not draft horses. They're definitely not riding horses. But they could still pull things. They're still, you know... beasts of burden kind of thing.
But they're probably 2-to-1 for a draft horse type thing.
Exactly. But even then, a single draft horse in a city that's not, you know, polluted by people is at 50 gold pieces in most cases.
Okay.
So
50
for this is good. Yeah.
Totally. Northerner discount.
Yeah.
He seems to, have really taken to Mabel for whatever reason. When she inspected the goats and the chickens, he really appreciated her authenticity.
Well, how much took a big sniff of their rear ends, really?
Brian's scared.
There, gotta get your hands in there, look at their teeth and gums.
So he sees you guys debating. He goes, okay, I did not mean to be so forward about taking your weapons. I understand. You are not idiots. I mean, I was never implying you are, but, you know. So I'll tell you what. I will deliver the same amount every 2 months for the same amount of gold 3 times over. And it may sound hefty, but I'm already giving you very good price on them, and I need to pay for my own life and guards to escort me to Bree'ek, and I have to go through the snow. And I hate snow. But it is not unfair, right? There are 45 gold pieces. And I just ask that you pay me in advance per shipment. So today, you give me 15 plus the 45 gold pieces, so 60 total. And I guarantee you 2 months from now I will deliver. And when I arrive 2 months from now, you give me another 45 gold pieces and I will come 2 months from then. That way you carry some of the risk. You see, it is a fair business. What do you think?
Well, that's a little bit more than I think right now the villagers are worth bargaining for, but that would have to be left up to Jontaine to see if they're able to afford that on their own. Right now, we're just worried about an initial shipment, and we're just looking at a contract to see if livestock provided should be arranged or not.
Well, you so wish you take the current offer of 15, but I promise you, you would not regret setting up these people. Jontaine looks and he goes, I have never held 45 gold pieces in my entire life, so no, we cannot afford that. But we could, he looks at him, we could, sir, give you very good lumber that we could place in your hands that you could take to Aelioth if you were willing to extend your journey, and you could trade there for a very good price. And that would make it so that we wouldn't have to leave Bree'ek, but we would only give you the lumber in exchange for the food. Because it's kind of lumber. And
the finest!
Do you have a sample of this lumber? No, I think not. So only weapons in your cart. Not look like people who sell lumber to me.
I think we can agree that we'll take this, and I'll kind of hand him over the 15 gold. And we will revisit the talk of contracts. We have a couple things to figure out in town first before we formalize things. Are you going to be here tomorrow?
I can be if it means I get potential business from you, lovely people. So dear to my heart.
Good sir, what is your name? You've honored us with, you know, your presence, but we do not know what to call you by.
Northerners cannot pronounce it. Just don't worry. Just call me whatever you want, so that everybody else calls me. Northerners cannot pronounce it.
I can pronounce it.
That sounds like a challenge, good friend.
It's Auxilian Marinathis.
OB for short.
Ox. I'm just going to mention maybe we just need to find who was originally doing these contracts with Bree'ek and see if we can get it going again. There must be someone.
John Tane kind of rubs his arm. He goes, What do you mean when you say contracts? Just out of curiosity.
I don't mean contracts, just whoever brought you the stuff before in exchange for lumber, we need to maybe see about getting them going again.
Oh,
I know
yeah,
why it stopped.
Yeah, fair enough. It was quite a few different people. There was one guy that visited us often, though. We could maybe try and find him.
I think that'd be a good idea. Just at least find out why they stopped and what we need to do to get them going again. At least they know they're getting good lumber. They know they're they know the route, they've done it quite a few times, so it might be easier to just get that going again.
Okay. I think we should go unload these weapons and then perhaps sort things out. So this guy gives us two horses. Does he give us a cart with that, or is we just using ours?
Just yours.
Just ours.
Okay. So who's pulling all the goats and chickens?
And what are we gonna put the chickens in?
Tossing everything on top. We got lots of rope.
Chickens with rope tied around the little legs.
Well, they're in cages.
I'm assuming they have cages.
Yeah, he said they were in cages.
Oh, okay, good. They have cages.
Yeah. I'm just saying, let's offload this other supplies, and then we can not have to worry about it.
Okay. Yeah, let's find that blacksmith we've dealt with before then.
Okay. All right. So you go and talk to the blacksmith. When he sees you pull up, he gives you a greeting. He doesn't exactly remember who you are, but treats you like he knows you, you know, like a good shopkeep does when he doesn't really remember your name, but acts like he does. So he kind of gives you, oh yeah, old friends, right. And you have a discussion. And when you tell him, because you guys are essentially mentioning that you have weapons, I'm assuming.
And we know that these blacksmiths really need weapons, so obviously it's not like we're...
When you tell him you've got weapons, his eyes just open up and he goes, I will 100% purchase those from you. I've got nothing to sell right now, and while I've got quite a bit of money from what I have sold, not as much as I could potentially have. So, I mean, I'll tell you what. I will sell these, because I can mark this up. I will buy these weapons from you at almost what I sell them for normally. And then guys from there, I mean, again, I'll be selling them for more. I hope you understand that. You make some money off these things. But I mean,
of course, obviously the man's here. Yeah.
Yeah. But as long as I'm making greater than zero on these weapons, sure. Yeah, 100%.
We don't want to be just going around selling one at a time to different people. I'd rather just.
Oh, yeah. You know. Yeah, exactly. Convenience for you, money for me. I think it benefits everybody.
Win win.
What does everyone think? Just get rid of it?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Okay.
All right, how many are you giving away? Or not giving away, how many are you selling? Minus, obviously, what you sent away with the villagers.
Yeah, and the villagers could even use those weapons to sell or barter for anything they want to bring back with them, or lodging, that kind of thing.
Yeah, and
actually,
I will say...
They'll be lucky enough they're not going to get attacked for their weapons.
The guy will say, yeah, I mean, if you have other people around that also have weapons that they don't need, by all means, I will happily take it off their hands as well. So how many weapons are you selling, this guy?
Well, I'll be honest, I don't actually have in inventory what all the weapons were on the cart. I never got that.
That's right.
It's just
that's
a cart of weapons.
Right. Yeah.
Although, I do have a bunch of our own loot that we could also sell and make some money off of too, if you guys are interested. I have that separately.
Yeah, just dump it all. Armor, weapons, anything we don't need, just dump it all.
Okay.
Probably get a better price for it anywhere else, that's for sure.
And you guys had said you gave about one sword to every three villagers before, right? So there's about 20 out right now.
No, one or two per group.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, one or two per group.
Yeah.
Okay, so there's more like.
Because I can tell you, on ourselves, we have two crossbows, 18 daggers, a falchion, short sword, and four scimitars.
Wow.
That's our personal.
Sorry. Go ahead, Scott.
No, I was just wondering, because I remember I took one of the crossbows. Is that
That's an addition. That was mine that I gave you because I don't use it.
Side note, perfect. Don't sell any of the bolts, though.
No, I kept those.
No.
Yeah,
okay,
no.
Good.
That Felchin is an exotic greatsword if you want that, Almagar. I don't know if you use stuff like that.
Oh.
But it's not in 5e, I don't think. It's in 3.5. But,
I was just going to say, would there be a benefit to that over my great axe?
It would, yeah, as far as mechanically, it would work exactly the same way, essentially. But yeah, it's essentially a giant scimitar. It's like a two-handed scimitar, essentially. So it's got this big old curved blade.
That's pretty terrifying.
That's pretty terrifying. I'm just trying to think if it...
Well, regardless, let me give you the prices for everything, and let's just go down the list. I'll tell you what the prices are. You guys write them down, though. I'm just looking at a sheet here. So.
All right.
So start with the first thing you had there.
Short sword.
Okay, how many?
I just got one.
Oh, just one short sword.
Yeah.
All right, he will give you 5 gold pieces for it.
Okay. And so you don't want the falchion there? Should we hold on to it just in case?
If it doesn't give me an actual bonus, I'm trying to think too. Would it be more?
How much is it worth? Let's change his mind by how much it's worth.
He'll give you 20 gold pieces for it, only because he's not sure as many people will buy it.
Right.
Just sell it. Just sell it. You're a barbarian.
Yeah, and I don't think I want something more practical, like something that's, yeah, I don't know. I think that would be a little overkill for
Okay. Four scimitars.
Okay. 40 gold pieces. Not each, obviously. I'll give you totals.
Oh, okay.
He said 18 daggers?
Yes.
18 daggers?
I kind of hoarded them.
Okay, so he'll give you a gold piece each, so 18 gold for those.
Does anyone want any of those before I get rid of them?
No, just get rid of them.
Okay. And 2 crossbows.
Are they? Yeah, they're light crossbows. Yeah.
Yeah.
He'll give you 10 gold pieces each, so 20 total.
And then I'll sell 2 short swords as well for 10 each, I believe it, or 5 each.
5 each, yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. And then you're selling everything that's in the cart too as well, right?
Yes.
Okay, so are we in agreement that 6 swords were given out from the cart? Does that sound about right?
Yeah.
Okay. Which means there is... 14 swords left in there still. There was about, 15. There was 21 in there total. So, and they are short swords.
5 each.
Yeah, I'm just taking a look because there was a couple that were not short swords in there buried as well. Yeah, so there's 10 short swords, so that's 50 gold pieces total for that. And then there was 5 long swords, and it'll give you 10 per for those, so 50 gold pieces there.
Does he want a donkey?
He points at Necromancer. If you're talking about that thing, hell.
I'll laugh. So I'll ask him if there's any other news. Now that we've done business, is there any other news that, you know, we just got back from town?
Well, that nasty business, you were here for that, right?
Unfortunately.
That occurred last time, yeah. So I guess those guys, I don't know if that's who they're really after, but in all the commotion... the current lord of Aredell was killed. No one even knew it was him. I guess he had snuck into the party. He had a tendency to do that, go out as a kind of civilian. A lot of people wear masks and stuff in those parties, so nobody had any idea it was him. And the stupid bastard got himself killed. So now you've got every other damn noble brother, sister, cousin, uncle from the Iskallon family fighting over who should be Lord of Aredell. You know, all on the brink of a damn war with Fellhorn as well, which is just craziness. Although, I'll be honest, I've heard a lot less talk about war with them lately and more just about, you know, what's going on in the city.
Any favorites?
As far as useful or as far as fun? Because,
As far as we want to keep our heads, who's going to win?
Well, rightly, his brother probably has the best claim to the seat in the city. But I don't know much about how the whole, you know, passing of lordship happens in Aredell. They all seem to have different opinions about it. But yeah, it seems to be his brother that has the biggest support in the city. Although his sister as well is right up there. She's, you know, walking the streets half the time, garnering support. Well, I don't much know why. It really doesn't come down to us as to who gets voted or who gets brought it in. It's not like we have a vote or anything else. But he kind of leans in, looks about, says, I honestly think they're garnering support in case it ends in some kind of a revolt or revolution, to be honest. But
revolution? What is that?
Way for a lot of stupid people to get themselves killed.
Sounds like a terrible thing.
If you ask me, I like to keep my nose out of it. I listen, but I don't really care. One lord is no different than the other. The Iskallon family has always been the Iskallon family. They kill all each other for all I really care. So that's my opinion on it.
Well, if you need any on completely unrelated, if you need any extra muscle around while you hawk your wares, we would be able to provide that if you so desired.
Yeah.
I know it's probably a little dangerous because we do have a few refugees we came across that are looking for work, and we're trying to find them work around the city.
That kind of work, I see. Yeah, I'll let you know if you find anything. However, if you folks looking for work, I've never obviously seen you in action, but you survived the events that night and you look fairly well equipped. If you're ever in, you know, the mood to kind of get on a little bit of adventuring work, make some good coin from that, head down to, you know, check out a few of the taverns in town here. There's a couple in particular, Golden Librum, personal favorite of mine. I have a friend there who I know is looking to recruit a few people, but I don't know. He probably has had luck of it by this point. But yeah, check the place out. Maybe we'll be able to find some work. But no, sorry, as far as refugees, I'll let you know if anything comes up. But honestly, I don't need any other working hands right now. I've already brought on two new apprentices in the wake of the current events. So.
Fair enough. But any other muscle, perhaps? Some guards or anything like that? We do have a few trained men.
Oh, your refugees know how to fight.
Some of them.
I have the occasional shipment to go get iron from the east. It's never bad to have a few extra men there if they want to stick around, but my next one isn't for a couple more 10 days, so I don't know how long they're willing to stick around without work. But I pay well.
Fair enough. Many thanks, Master Blacksmith, and we'll perhaps be in touch next time we have another shipment. Depending on how things go, it might be sooner than later.
Yeah, fair enough. All right, well, don't get yourselves, put your necks out there too much. Some of these guys who've come into town lately, my God, I've seen rough people, but this doesn't begin to describe them. So, you know, you look capable, but don't go.
At that, Antimaeus will bow out of the conversation unless anyone else wants to continue it.
Are we still at the blacksmith? Sorry, I had to step out. Yeah. Yeah,
he told us to go to the inn.
Which inn?
One of the inns.
The
Golden Librum.
Oh, okay.
If we wanted work.
I wanted to sell those, what was his name? Tardik that we fought there. I popped the earrings out of him. Mm-hmm. I wanted to sell those earrings and his red ruby ring.
Blacksmith will buy these if you want them. or if you want him to. He's honest in that, you know, a lot of it's not really the market right now for these kind of items. Most of that's being sold, but I mean, yeah, for the rings and stuff, he'll give you like 5 gold pieces for a lot of them.
For the 4 earrings and the ring?
Yeah. And he'll be honest. He's like, you know, it's probably not the best price, but it's all they're really worth to me at this point.
You should keep the ruby ring. It goes with your sword.
Yeah.
Okay, sure. And so how much for the 4 earrings then?
I'll give you a gold piece each, so 4.
Okay, yeah, sure. I'll sell that then.
Fine. Okay, so he tosses over 4 gold pieces your way.
And sticks in his nose.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Alright.
There's still, like, bloody flesh stuck to him.
Alright, what would you guys like to do?
How much money did we get there, Mabel?
Oh, altogether, we have...
a lot.
Enough for a down payment on a shipment of more goods.
Well, honestly, like, Antimus is kind of...
203 gold.
Yeah.
But yeah.
I think Antimus will say, I think we cut out the middleman in the sense of we encourage
and
our friends...
That's not including all of our gold from previous. That's just this.
Yeah. No, Antimus will say, I think we encourage Bree'ek to send their supplies with the horses that we'll purchase and send the supplies to whichever town they choose, and with those, you know, timber or whatever products they sell, they can purchase grain. I don't think we need to set up anything else, but that's up to the group to decide, but I think we have done a lot already.
Yeah, and we have that one contract possibly if they decide to go forward with it. Set up
exactly
for them.
Exactly. And if John Tane wants us to look into the previous contract to see why they canceled, that's totally fine, but I don't think we need to do 45 gold every 2 months for our herd of animals.
And there's no there's no reason why they couldn't make the trip out to come and get them.
Exactly.
Save
right?
themselves some money, right. and they can. They have to, well, possibly not have to, but they can also bring some lumber in and, you know.
Just sell it for gold and then trade it for, buy animals with it, right?
Yeah.
That's my feeling, too, and obviously Antimus wants to hold on to that cash for other purposes the group might need, but, because we need to live through the winter.
Yeah, just try to find a place for us to stay, right? That could be.
What does Pythagoras think? Should we go and check on why the contract was not fulfilled, or should we just kind of be, you know, they have the supplies to get them going?
I think we should follow up on the contract, just because they have already apparently, they're expecting this supply, so they've already paid for this.
Yeah, I am interested.
So it's...
No, they haven't paid. They pay when the supplies arrive. They trade, right?
Yeah, but
it's kind of like
they did say earlier though that this shipment was already paid for, that it should have already come.
True, right? That's right.
No, it was the shipment should come, but they always pay when it arrives at Bree'ek.
Right.
Right. Yeah. It's kind of so like, hey, come to our town, we'll trade with you. Is the agreement? It's
true,
not.
It's not an actual contract, right?
Yeah. Yeah. No, so, it's just come over and we'll give you timber.
Yeah. So hey, do you not need timber anymore?
Yeah, and that's pretty much all the conversation is going to be. Is it too dangerous? What happened? So we might have to encourage Bree'ek to send their own timber, you know, north, south, east, or west, or whatever way they want to send it by themselves. Which might be better in the long run, because then you get what it's worth in the town.
And I think it's shorter to head north, right? From Bree'ek to head north, I think it was shorter than head south.
Make a couple sleds for them and they'll be happy in the wintertime.
Yeah.
I think between Maple and I, we should make some pretty good
timber
sleighs.
Well, speaking of which, we should probably then pick up some nails while we're here at the blacksmith's.
Okay. Mm. Yeah. All right, he'll for the stuff you're giving him, he'll just throw in some whatever supplies you need.
Okay, I'm just gonna write down jar of nails, just for the record.
Gives you toenails.
Fresh. Oh.
I've only got gout in one foot.
I think
if anyone gets hungry enough, there's a jar of nails there.
Oh, Jesus.
Pickled nails.
Hey, if we're going to eat horses, why not? No, that's worse. I'd eat a horse before I'd eat
toenails. I'd eat a horse before I'd eat a toenail. Yeah. Every day.
I think, even eat a horse now. I think Maple and I wanted to go to a tailor.
Yes.
Okay. What are you guys looking for?
I need some sinew. So okay. I can sew.
Okay, you're just looking for like how much you need?
Oh, a lot.
Okay,
200 gold worth.
How much did you make?
Well, I don't know, like a small bolt enough to last like a couple months.
Okay, 5 gold.
Woo! Well, I can afford that. Well, it's coming out of group loot. Yeah.
Is there anything else you guys need to purchase in town?
I just wanted to see if
don't you need
get that jacket made?
Healers.
I was trying
healers
to get
and healers kits. What we
and healers kits.
Yeah, if you're willing to wait a couple days and give the person 15 gold for the custom work, they'll definitely make the jacket for you out of that cloaker skin.
Nah, it's all good. I'll probably get Maple to make it.
Okay. All right.
But yeah, I would definitely would like to get some healer kits. So.
Okay.
Like 5 uses, if I can.
Yeah, okay.
We have to get some rations too, people.
Yeah, I haven't been too hardcore about that, but I might start, so you probably make sure you all have food.
I still got some rations, I'm good.
Yeah, if you tell us how much rations are per day as well, Alex.
Yep. So for the amount of supplies you need for like 5 uses of a healer's kit, they're probably you could find everything you need for like 2 gold pieces.
Perfect. Okay.
We might as well get like you said 2 gold pieces for 5 uses?
Yeah.
Oh. I mean I don't camera, but I'll probably grab some as well. I'll grab the same 2 gold worth.
2? Okay.
Yeah, sounds good.
I'll take that at a group loot too, Scott, so don't take it out.
Oh, okay.
Why don't we just divvy up group loot so that everyone has their amounts on them?
Why, so you can go gamble yours away again?
No. Yeah, pretty much.
No problem.
But it's just so that if you want to buy something big or whatever, you just kind of know where you're at.
Don't have to keep going to the treasure room. You're like, Maple, can I buy some healer's kits?
And then we can just all give Alex a shopping list right now and then just be done.
That's how they did it in our village, Scott. Or Algamar. You should know.
Yeah.
So go to the woman if you need the money.
Behind every great king.
we need rations, Alex.
What quality of rations are you looking for?
Like winter iron ration.
Okay, so you're looking at about 8 silver piece per day for winter quality iron rations that will last for like a month.
Okay.
But if you're looking for things that are going to be a little more indefinite time, you're looking at a couple gold pieces per day.
Couple gold? Okay, so you're fine with us like deciding how many we buy later on when we decide to leave and then just taking it out of our money?
Whenever you leave the city, yeah, you can decide at that point. We don't need to write this second.
So a couple gold pieces for... Couple gold pieces or 8 silver pieces for 8
silver, yeah.
And sorry, the 8 silver was how long
last?
8
silver will still last you for a month. Like they'll stay about a month, but once they hit that point, they're getting a little old and probably not that healthy to eat.
Okay.
Whereas the 2 gold piece per day ones, that will last for months, plural. Potentially.
You can forget about it.
Yeah.
Okay. Is there anything else anyone needs, or are we gonna?
Yeah, I'll probably buy the good gold.
Stop playing shop roleplay with Alex.
I can only roleplay so many shopkeeps, guys.
Yeah.
Okay, so you guys have gotten everything you're looking for at this point, then? Oh, so you wanted uses of a healer's kit too? Did you not?
Okay. I'm gonna get in on those healer kits.
Okay, so the 2 gold for 5 uses or whatever.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay. Anything else?
I'd like to go to the my favorite inn or tavern, the Coward's Tear.
Sure. Okay. All right. So you head into the Coward's Tear, and it is. Or sorry, is everybody going to accompany Pi? I guess into this place, or are you?
Actually, no. I want to do one more thing while we're in the trading district area.
Okay.
Is there anyone that looks like they? I don't know, do potions or, like, possibly, like, voodoo, witchcraft, you know. Not magic, but, you know, like, shaman stuff.
Doesn't appear to be, no. It's pretty conventional merchants. If these people do exist, they've been pushed kind of to other places only because, you know, the practical goods have come out, and it looks like the guards are kind of promoting this type of behavior as well. So nothing super, super obvious, unfortunately, no.
Okay, well, how about I'm going to go wander around the city, and I'll meet back up with you guys at one of the inns.
I'm going to the Coward's Tear.
You're going to the Coward's Tear? Okay.
How about we split up the gold first before you go wandering around?
Oh, yeah, okay. That's probably a good idea.
200 gold. And are you okay going by yourself? Do you want anyone to go with you? Because I don't have to go anywhere in particular.
If you
want to
come hang out, sure. I've got some...
Go ahead, Alex.
I got a sack of rabbit's feet I want to get rid of.
Oh, that's right.
I literally have 48 rabbit's feet.
Nice. We should open our own little stall.
I technically could, but I'm gonna make stuff for winter, so that's why I've been hoarding all the like the animal bones and pelts and stuff.
Nice. Well, I'll be adventuring. You'll just sit in the inn knitting and sewing.
Yeah, pretty much.
Who wants mittens?
Is there anything else anyone else wants to accomplish?
If we're here for the winter, I don't know if we're going to be leaving to do little adventures.
Well, whatever. And that's a decision, I think, is pretty much like, do we go with them back to Bree'ek and help them out, or do we stay here and adventure?
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah,
I'm totally fine either way.
Yeah, so am I. I mean...
Well, I personally, as far as story and jobs and things, we'd have more in the city here probably, but in Bree'ek, if we were to go back to Bree'ek and winter there, we have a place already that they've already given us, and we can then focus on clearing spiders and goblins and whatnot.
I don't want to just like stay in a city for a season. That's really boring. Like,
yeah,
I don't want to play Farm Simulator.
I think Alex might have stuff for us here in the city, like right with the nobles and stuff, but...
We already know we can go to the tavern and get jobs, and the blacksmith already said we can, you know, go with him for the iron shipments. Like, there's tons of stuff we can do here.
Exactly. Yeah. Either way is cool. I mean, the goblins are pretty interesting. I don't mind going back and figuring out what's going on with that, and the wolves and
stuff. If I never see those guys again.
So everyone, you get 56 gold and 17 silver apiece. I'm just gonna leave the copper in group loot because we only got
how much silver? Sorry,
17.
56 gold.
56 gold.
Decent.
And just a side note, we gotta keep in mind that we have that other guy as well. So from the future, we need to actually like pay him.
Yes.
Right.
Well, just keep in mind when we're talking money in the group, he's around now.
Yeah.
Like, we'll do this in secret, obviously, but... But, with Alias, I agree, like, I'm totally for figuring out what those green devils things are. So, that's a total thing that Antimaeus is kind of interested in.
That might be something a little more level appropriate, too.
Well, and Antimaeus will say... well, it's up to the group, but Antimus is very interested in, like, spider venoms and, you know, all those type of things, just various different
I also have a score to settle with a certain old fucking witch that I want to kill. So, I would love to go back there and hunt her down.
Oh, yeah, sorry, I was just like, who? Not that Antimus would forget, but I was just like, what? Mm-hmm. What are you talking about?
I think we all would love to get...
That's the worst thing your in-game character would know, and you're so fucking clueless.
Yeah.
Like, that's
All right, so you guys divvied up your coin. You figured out what you're doing.
No, I can do it. I was just
sorry, Alex. Quick question.
No worries.
I asked the young lady if she needs anything.
Mm. Oh, can you tell?
She thinks for like a good hard few moments. She looks like she's being very kind of introspective and thoughtful about this. She goes, "I guess it depends on how long you guys are willing to keep me around."
We're probably heading back to Bree'ek with the refugees and trying to set up, but...
That's not what I mean. I'm not going back home to Bree'ek. This, she looks around the city, is a little bit more my pace. For everything that's happened, I don't want to go back to a farmer's life. So what I mean by that is, do you need me to be killing things with you? And if you do, let's talk about what you can get me. If you don't worry about it.
She's a keeper, Antimus. I think she likes you.
I can set you up both places. I have people here that can start your profession. I think I speak for the group in saying that numbers are definitely an advantage. We have just discussed the options of clearing out the spider's den near Bree'ek is one, and then investigating these goblins, I believe they were called, which would also be a significant fight that we would love to have extra numbers with. So by no means, if we go back to Bree'ek, am I going to stick a shovel in your hand.
Well, maybe
unless
two.
It's burying people. Yeah.
When you say goblins, you mean like the little creatures from like fairy tales kind of thing? Like the little bastards that came to our village and killed a bunch of people?
I'll point to Alias. You know that like shoulder that just keeps getting worse?
I'll just drop my sleeve a little.
I am so with you if you're going to go kill those little green things, because they're the reason why I don't have a family anymore. It was bad enough with the damn rituals, but then those things started showing up. Yeah, I'll go kill some of those little guys.
Okay, fair. I'll definitely be your sponsor for the time being until Pythagoras feels that you're ready, just because we don't want to put you into something that is a little beyond you at this point. We've done that before, and we're not going to make that mistake again. So we would love to have you along, and I'll teach you what I know, and everyone will teach you skills that they know, and you will definitely gain a great advantage to coming with us.
Okay, and I'm not afraid. I'm willing to do whatever, so...
Perfect.
All right.
What should we call you?
You know, I've been
thinking
real name or not.
You've asked me this a few times, and I know I haven't really talked much. I've been thinking to myself, I'm reinventing a life. Maybe I should, you know, pick a new name. That's kind of why I've been thinking about this a bit.
Then no answers necessary at this time.
Yeah, I don't know if I really decided, to be 100% honest.
Totally fine.
For now, you can just refer to me as, like, I don't know, whatever. She, her.
Excellent.
I won't be offended.
Well, she, would you require anything at this point to continue journeying with us?
I mean,
some rations.
Yeah, well, I'll need food, and I wouldn't mind with something to defend myself with beyond a dagger. And, you know, if I get some of those fancy clothes you guys wear that block blades, I wouldn't mind that as either. But, you know, that's a wish list, whatever you want to do.
Can I just nix selling one of my short swords to the blacksmith then?
Yeah, no
worries. Sure. Then I'll give that to her.
Okay.
Did we have any leather armor by chance there, Maple?
No, we sold it all previously.
Okay.
In Alia?
What was that guardsman wearing, Alex? And was it approximately her size?
He's a big guy, so no, it would have to be refitted to her, but he was wearing like a studded leather.
Okay. I'll tell her that she can help me to acquire some, and that with Pythagoras' approval, we'll try to get that done later tonight.
Yeah, sure.
I don't know if anyone else maybe would like to join, but that's the plan.
Okay. All right. So that's what you'll do later tonight. So who's all splitting off? Who's doing what? Where are you guys going?
Well, I want to go back to Obi there, and I want to see if he can maybe, if he's interested, maybe he's willing to purchase them, but I doubt it. Or if he knows where I might be able to find maybe somewhere to, because I got a whole bunch of rabbit's feet, so that's why I was kind of looking for someone who maybe did a little bit of voodoo or something and wanted some good luck charms. So I figured since he was nice enough and he liked me, I'll go back to him.
He goes, ah, hello, you have come back to give me my 45.
Oh, just before you start, are you coming with me, Algamar?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So he goes, ah, you have come back to give me my 45 gold pieces for the delivery? Yes, I told you it was a very good idea.
It is a very good idea, but the gentlemen there are still discussing matters. I have more of a personal request.
Oh, okay. What can I do for you?
Oh, well, I was wondering if you knew of anyone who might be looking for particular goods, more or less good luck charms and such in and around the areas, and I'll just kind of dump over my bag that I have, my sack of rabbit's feet, and I'll show them, like,
yes.
Some I've just recently procured along the ways.
You and your Northlander superstitions. Yes, yes, yes. We could probably go to the healer in town, so she calls herself. She seems to use these kind of items when, you know, deplaguing people. I don't know. She'd probably be gullible enough to sell those too.
People will believe anything.
Yes, they will.
So where is she?
And she gives you some directions.
Does she have a name?
I do not know. I've never really met her myself, but
oh,
I've been there.
She's just self-proclaimed healer of the city, huh?
Yes, it smelled very badly. So, yeah.
Well, I'll toss him a gold piece and thanks for your time.
Yeah, very generous. You come back anytime, I'll tell you what. Tell your friends 44 gold pieces.
I'll just kind of do like a yeah.
Yeah, I'm like, I was like, ooh, I'll think I can spare a silver piece, and then she beat me to it. I'm like, okay, there we go. Pretty good.
Pi, are you going to the inn to just, like, hang out for a few hours, or are you staying there or anything like that?
Oh, I'm just gonna go hang out.
Okay, like, Antimaeus is gonna ask, if he goes scouting, are you gonna be there when I come back in a few hours?
Yeah, most likely, yeah.
Okay.
Okay. I'll join in the tavern there as well.
Okay.
Alright. Almagar and Maple, this whole thing doesn't take too long. I'm assuming you're going to the healer's place. Really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you walk in to see this kind of thin old woman, and she's currently got somebody lying down on a table, and they're completely naked, and they're lying down there, and you just hear this, she goes, hush, hush, you'll feel much better soon. And he's got, like, leaves poking out of his mouth. and she's dangling some kind of like incense above his face. And then she goes, "Ha!" And she kind of hits him in the head with a little incense dangler. She goes, "There you go. You can take out the leaves now. You should be fine, young man." And he's like, "Oh, gods, I sure hope so." And he slowly puts on his trousers, and then he heads out. And she looks to you and goes, "Ah, I did not see you there. Sorry about that. Welcome. What ailments can I cure for you?"
"Oh, well, actually, we're here to see if maybe we can help you out in some simple trade."
She kind of almost ignores you, Maple, and looks at Almagar and kind of grabs you by the chin, Almagar, and goes, "Look very pale. Perhaps you could use some herbal medicine, some teas. Ah, yes, a tea of frog bottom. I think that would be good for you." Oh.
And what would that tea help me with?
"You feel right better there, Sonny." She looks around and grabs this little, little bottle. "Ah, yes, tea of frog bottom. Fresh frogs. Make you feel much better." Sorry, you were saying?
I'll toss down the sack. "Are you interested in any of this?"
She opens up. "Oh, they smell wonderfully putrid." "I'll take them all from you."
Like, fresh lot.
"I'll tell you a secret. Rabbit's feet don't do anything, but they're easy to fool the colorful ones. Unlike frog's bottom, which is 100% real and helps greatly."
Do you use these herbs to actually heal? Like, if someone has like wounds, or like if someone gets stabbed, do you have anything that would help them?
I can't seal flesh that's been broken, boy. Aside from good old fashioned string, but I'll keep the infection away and the disease at bay, as I like to say.
Yes, that's definitely a good thing to have.
So she goes, "How much do you want for the feet?"
Knowledge check. How much would I roughly estimate trade?
Give me an intelligence check. Let's see how what you're thinking.
8.
All right. I mean, there's a lot of them, and a lot of other things today, so you know, maybe like a couple gold pieces.
"Well, normally, how much do you sell for? Like, is this a common item around here,
or is this little written thing?" Where she has one hanging from the wall that shows the price, but your eyes are quick enough to see what she was selling it for. She's selling them for 5 silver apiece.
Okay.
But she's like, "Oh," pretending she's stretching. "Oh, I don't know. Making things are so difficult."
"So, how about, I'll go a little bit under. We'll both profit from this. How about 144 silver for the lot?"
Sorry, how many are in the bag?
"I have 48.
Right, okay. She thinks about it.
"You make
Okay. Sure.
Deal.
Have that kind of coin." Kind of looks around. He goes,
"We could trade for a few items if you have anything of similar values."
That's actually worth more than it actually does something, unlike the rabbit's feet.
She goes, "No, no, no, don't accuse me of not being able to pay." She goes, yeah, "This should do." And she puts this big sack of coins, and she goes, "That should be about right." She ties it up and hands it over. When she opened it up, it was all copper pieces.
I was kind of pushed back. "You might want to recount that."
"Okay, what would you like? I'm sure we can trade for something. Is there anything you're looking for?"
"Well, what's on the menu? Like, or sorry, not on the menu. What is she? Like,
yeah, yeah. Her little list there. What kind of goodies does she have? But I'll definitely take a few sticks of incense if she's got it.
Cream of eel's tongue, you know, tea of frog bottom, purple. Just gonna call it purple, whatever that is. She's got incense sticks. She's got rabbit's feet. She's got, you know, toad eyes. The whole works. Lots of components.
Does she have beaver's tail?
Yes.
I will take some beaver's tail.
Okay.
Sounds like the weirdest order ever
The equivalent exchange of beaver's tail for feet?
Well, there's a couple other items, so okay. We'll see.
All right.
Beaver's tail.
Yeah.
moose antler.
Yeah.
And I need a quill from a quill or two from a loon.
She will give you 3 quills, a full thing moose thing antler. That's the word I was looking for. That she said was very hard to find and to get, so you know it's gonna cost you a premium. And then she'll also give you like 5 beaver tails. And she says that'll be an equivalent exchange for the feet.
Sold, unless there's anything you want, Elmagar.
I think I'm good.
It'll cure you right up. Anything that ails you. Fresh frog bumps.
I was like, hey, could I have a little sample?
Ah, just take it. All right, you've robbed me enough. Now leave an old woman be with her rabbit's feet.
Well, just now, if you are interested, I do have a few other items.
No, enough trade for today. I'm not a trading person. I want coin as much as the next person. Be gone! Go! Have that frog's bottom tea, young man. You'll feel much better. Fresh frogs, it's important.
Can I roll intelligence to see, or maybe survival? Like, do I know what frog's bottom tea is?
Roll intelligence.
10.
Nope, no idea. Never heard of it before. It smells awful, though, even through the bottle.
Frog's bottom.
All right. So all right. I assume you guys finish up there. This whole ordeal did not take you too long. You know that Pi is going to the Coward's Tier. Do you want to join him there?
Well, actually, I'm going to look at Elmagar, and I'll be like, Do we want to go back to the tavern right now, or did we want to go look at that other possible contact there to see why they stopped shipments?
Maybe we should just go. Yeah, we've got some time. Just inquire, or just
inquire about it. I mean,
okay. Yeah.
All right, so you guys will go and look around at for the shipments. Take a look. Okay, I'm gonna jump over to Pi and Elias for a moment. So you guys arrive at the Coward's Tier. It is full packed of people. There is one table open kind of in the corner, though, that looks like you guys can sit at it if you so wish.
Yeah, I'll go sit there.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you sit, and after a few moments, a young man who seems to be doling out drinks drops by and says, hello, fine masters. Is there anything I can get for you?
It's just me and Alias, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, 2 ales.
Yes, of course. I will be right back with those.
Is there, like, someone playing music in here?
Yep, there sure is. So there's several people kind of doing a band. There's a drum player, a flute player, and somebody on a lute, and they're jamming out, and everybody seems to be having a good time. It's quite loud, lots of people talking, quite a few dice games going on, that sort of thing.
Yeah, I'd like to talk to the guy at the flute.
Okay.
When he's not busy playing.
Sure. Yeah, so they play a couple songs, you guys have a drink or two, and they kind of take a break. The lute player gets up there and just does some solo stuff. You see the flute player take back a couple swings of something. And yeah, it's probably a good time to approach him.
Hey, not bad today. That's pretty good, solid flute playing you got there.
Oh, well, thank you, kind master. I didn't catch your name.
Oh, I'm Pythagoras Matthias Alistair, Elric, the greatest hero of all the lands.
Oh, my, what a name. I am Frol.
Hello, Frol. I'm in need of a bard to tell my tales. Would you be interested in such a job?
Oh, no, the bard days are far in my past, young man. I just like to play the taverns now. I'm more of a merrymaker these days than I am a professional musician. Perhaps in my younger years I would have been happy to accompany you, but not now.
Oh, that's a shame. Do you know of anyone that would be interested?
Most of us city men who play music in the taverns are elder in our years, and I'll be honest, if you see a young person doing the same, they've probably not got a whole lot going on in their lives. You might not want to take them on either. But no one comes to mind specifically. I'm sorry.
That's a shame. Oh well. Well, nice talking to you.
You as well. Thank you very much. It's nice to interact with some of the patrons sometimes.
Yeah, so I'll go back and sit down with Alias. Knock back a few.
They start playing some music before long, and they start playing a tune you're pretty familiar with. Like, in this area, a lot of the same music gets used over and over again. Sometimes the musicians change out specific words or names, that sort of thing. And they start singing about this heroic, like, dragon slayer, but when they get to the name, the guy, like, blurts out your name as quickly as he possibly can. Like,
awesome.
They butcher it. But he's like, thanks, man. And then they make it into like a song. Have you ever heard one of those Irish kind of drinking songs? Perfect. Where you try and speed up the tempo and everybody tries to... So soon enough, the whole tavern is trying to like blurt out the already impossible name to sing it like really, really fast. And yeah, everybody seems
really awesome.
But yeah, so anyways, anything you two would like to do here? Or are you just going to wait for this to arrive?
I don't know. Do you want to do anything here, Alias?
Not in particular. No. I'll join in the merrymaking of the singing and whatnot. Okay. That sounds like a load of fun. Yeah. On a couple drinks.
Okay. All right. Awesome. Antimaeus, you said you were going to go scout. What would you like to do?
I'll invite she. Okay. And then... the other guy, which I don't remember his name, the burned neck guy that's not the gut wound guy.
Brysa.
Brysa, yeah.
I'll invite him to come with me if he wants. And then I'll tell John Tane to probably start gathering his people into a group and letting them know what's going on. And that he can take the wagons and carts and stuff. Yeah. And the horses.
All right.
Well, except Beth. I'll take Beth.
Bryce is gonna kind of look at you and be like, yeah, I mean, I guess I could go with you. I was not gonna lie, I've been in a position to really go down and have a few drinks for a little bit, so I was thinking that maybe I'd
join. You could go catch up with Pythagoras.
If you don't mind, I think I'd rather do that.
Yeah, no problem. If you want to just skulk off, that's fine.
Yeah. Thanks, man. And he just runs off. Glad you understand.
Okay, and then I'm going to go back to the guard house thing.
She slash her will just be like...
Why is she all emo? Long... Sorry, did I miss something?
No, she shook her head and said... Just because of Brysa.
Yeah, well, I'll turn around and be like... Good riddance.
Before long, Brysa joins you, Pythagoras, and Alias at the bar. He just sits down, he starts wearing drinks, doesn't ask if he comes in or anything else, he does. Grasps his neck once in a while. Oh. Alright. Okay, so, sorry, Jordan. So you told John Tane to do his thing, take the horses,
scatter the people. Yeah. And then I'll take mine, and then I'm just gonna go try to find this guard and where he's hanging out and where he spends his leisure time.
Okay. Give me an investigate check.
Sure. this the gate. 16.
Alright. Yeah, you trace him back to this small, kind of crappy tavern near the guard gate. But near the gate where all the guards are posted. And he sounds like he's in there. You can hear his voice kind of bellowing above everybody else in the crowd.
Perfect. Walk into the police station to murder someone. Context. This is not like French Revolution where dueling is outlawed or anything like that?
Not to your knowledge, okay. No. Never has been an Aredell previously.
Not that I've ever experienced. Balls. I'll ask around, actually, to see how long he's been in there.
Okay.
Trying to judge how drunk this guy is.
Sure, give me a charisma check.
14.
Okay. Yeah, you find a couple people that visibly look irritated every single time the guy opens his mouth. So, gravitating towards them, they say, oh, he's been in here for only like an hour, and he's already piss drunk, and he is... I hate the guy. I hate the guy so much. You also notice that these irritated people are actually wearing the correct guard uniforms in this place.
Yeah.
So there are still a few of them. There's just not many. Most of this place looks like work for hire.
Well, then I'll inquire, like, why is it gone so crappy? Like, I left for literally, like, 20 days.
There was the attack on the festival, which you may or may not have been aware of. About that time, actually about 20 days ago or so. And several guards died there, but unfortunately some events followed, and we think one of the guys that was associated with it killed a ton of guards at the gate with poison. And then, only 5 or 6 days following that, there's another attack, which most people aren't aware of, so just...
I didn't hear about any other
sectors. The guy's a little drunk. He's like, you know, we were able to keep it under wraps, but more guards died in that one because we kept it under wraps than anything else. So we're very understaffed. So then we start having people flood in to get work as guards. Well, other things have been going crazy lately too. He kind of looks around. I don't know why. I just kind of feel like I trust you. Maybe it's the drinks. And his friend says, yeah, it's the drinks. Watch what you say. I goes, oh, I could probably tell you this because they're looking for people to actually help out with it. So I imagine it's not too secretive. So you've heard about the whole thing going on with Fellhorn, right? That we might
of be course.
Going to war.
Yeah.
Well, so normally when there's a good amount of guards and, you know, a living ruler of the town, there's
long live Aredell.
Yeah. Yeah. There's a fort. Over to the east, just a little close to Fellhorn, but not quite there. We have a lot of names for it, but I think officially it's called like Sun Shadow Keep or something along those lines. Something cryptic, you know how freaking people who name things are. Anyways, it's normally kept empty with a few kind of skeleton crew of guards, but when it's wartime, we generally station it again because it's a good kind of partway point between Fellhorn and us. We go to war, enough where it's useful to us to have it occupied.
Right.
So we didn't have enough people, but every group we've hired to go out there to check it out has died, or at least they haven't come back. So they and we're offering good coin for it. So we don't know what's going on.
And who might be the royal we?
We get orders from the nobility as to what kind of work like this we're able to give out. So I'll admit I get it from my captain and he tells me what to do. So I'm allowed to tell people essentially that, you know, they're looking for people.
I heard rumor that is there any discerning feature about this guy that I hate? Like a lazy eye or an eyebrow or something? Yeah.
Well, he looks like he's homeless. I mean, that doesn't say much in this kind of day and age, but he's very unkempt. He stinks. Maybe that's the biggest thing.
Yeah, okay, well, anything, you know, this, I heard rumor this obnoxious, stinky, you know, no good for nothing was charging peasants 5 gold apiece to come into the city the other day. Is that also the royal mandate? Yeah,
unfortunately, we've got no room, and we don't want, the nobility doesn't want squatters hanging around, so we're supposed to charge anybody that looks like they're going to be staying for a longer period than, you know, a week or two, that kind of coin, and nobody can reasonably afford that. So I mean, as you know, it's really just a tactic to get them to go away.
Interesting. Well, I would be appreciative if you could have him come out and have a conversation. I would like to talk with this man. If you have no hard feelings about such a circumstance happening.
This guy's eyebrows raise, he lets out a smile, and his buddy looks at you and goes, "Oh yeah, we'll get his attention if you want his attention."
I think we have an understanding that this man is a nuisance to the restoration of law and order, and halfway I would be happy to oblige.
Not the guy you're talking to, but his buddy says, "Hey, Burke, you ugly son of a cow! Get over here, you stinking piece of garbage!" And this big guy looks over and goes, pulls some meat out of his mouth. "Who's talking to me?" Walks over and he goes, "Oh, I see." Lipping grease off his hands, wavering around drunk. "You, I know you. I know what you're saying about me behind my back." The guy goes, "Your buddy here wants to talk to you." And he looks to you. He goes, "Oh, and I'll remember you."
And I'll like just keep backing up. Like intentionally heading towards an alley, but like just strategically backing up.
He stupidly follows you out of the inn. And essentially wherever you want to take him. He's got his fists like in front of his face. He's like, "I know where this is going. Give me your face. I'm going to make it pieces. I don't know how you got through the gate, but I'm going to break your gate." He's like walking around.
Okay. I will be like, I'll look past him to she. I'll be like, "She, take a swing."
"Not a woman." And then
I'll pull out my weapons and take a swing at him.
Yeah, he gets a slash across the back. Oh, he falls to the knees. And then you can just finish him right here if you really want to.
I'll do like one of those drawn out semantics and I'll say any last words.
He goes, "My back really hurts."
"That'll be 5 gold. And then I'll just slit his throat.
Oh, all right.
He claps to the ground, stinky and all, dead.
I'll totally loot his corpse.
Just doing his job.
All right. The guy has 16 gold pieces on him.
Oh,
wow.
Nancy.
11 silver and 4 copper.
And he's wearing his armor. Does he have any weapon on him?
Yep. Yeah, he sure does. He has a long sword at his hip.
Okay.
Sorry, he's also got something that is essentially the equivalent of like medieval brass knuckles. He's not wearing them, but he's got them in like kind of hanging off his back. And they're actually like gloves that don't cover your whole hand, but they have spikes where your knuckles would be.
Oh, those are mine. I love them.
What's your face looks at them and goes,
"Oh,
I'd actually take those if I'll give you your sword back. That looks like a little bit of fun."
Done.
All right. So she takes them, puts them on, and starts pummeling this guy's body. She's like, "Oh yeah, I like this better." Wigs the blood off her knuckles.
This woman is sick.
And Timaeus is like emotionally confused. He's kind of like, "I shouldn't appreciate this."
Got a half chub.
Yeah, I know this is wrong, but I like it.
I I will take his stuff, like roll up the leather armor or studded leather and put it into my backpack, and then I'll just go have a conversation with the guards, maybe buy a couple of drinks, whatever that'll cost me for them. And, you know, say well met and all that.
Okay.
And then right, I'm just going to go sell the leather and try to buy her some. So if I can just, like, go to my fence or whatever and swap the studded for studded, that would fit her.
Sure. Yeah, so this place is pretty cheap. It costs you a whole silver to get these guys a couple drinks.
Okay.
This wilder is not too expensive. And yeah, you can get up to your fence and they'll definitely do that for you. No worries.
Okay.
They just had a fresh studded leather piece for a woman about her size come in recently. So strange.
And then if he wants two long swords as well.
Yeah, okay.
And that'll just be 5 gold each?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ah, sorry, for the long sword, he'll give you eight for those, sorry.
Okay. And then I'll go try to find the group.
Okay. All right. Jumping back to Almagar and Maple for a moment. Can you each give me investigate checks, please?
Maybe not Maple, but...
No, maybe not Maple, but...
She's just in the kitchen.
Yeah, no worries.
Where she belongs. No.
Oh.
I'm just kidding. It doesn't help when she's not there to hear it. But yeah. Defeats the purpose.
Yeah, what's up?
Need an investigate check, please.
Okay. 17.
Although there are a ton of merchants in this place, you manage to ask the right questions to the right people, and you get narrowed down to the guy you're pretty sure it is, because they've said that he's taken a lot of trips out to Bree'ek, and they only said there's like one guy that's off there, right? So, yeah, you meet with him. He's kind of this portly dude. He's trying to look pretty fancy, but he's got these kind of light blue robes that are all covered in muck and such from, you know, not really ever being cleaned. And he's currently talking to somebody, and he finishes up and looks to you two and says, "Ah, hello. If you're looking for somebody to carry goods somewhere, I apologize, but I've already been booked up for foreseeable future. But is there anything else I can do for you?"
Well, actually, we're just here to inquire about, the lack of trade with Bree'ek. They were expecting some shipments, but nothing ever came through.
Yeah, I meant to get up there again. You know, I know those people are depend on trade, but I'm pretty sure they trade at the Alias too. So I'm sure they're probably not too bad of a state. But I mean, if they sent you asking, maybe that's not the case. I don't know, but yeah, sorry, I've been so busy here. The money has all been in the city. I've barely had to leave once. It seems like it's getting a little oversaturated now, so I'll be, you know, taking some shipments out again. But I won't be heading north for quite a while. I'm actually going to be heading south soon. But that's all. Work was busy here. Didn't mean to put them out or anything else.
So no intentions of heading up north anytime soon for further trade then? Actually,
yeah, Bree'ek were good people and everything, but, you know... Maybe after the winter's over.
All right. Well, thank you.
Yeah, no worries.
And I guess unless there's anything you want to do, Almagar, we could head back to the inn now.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay. All right, so you guys at the inn are soon joined by Antimaeus and Burr, and as well as Maple and Almagar. So you guys are all sitting at the table. The guy asks if anybody else wants drinks, and they bring it. Mm-hmm. And yeah.
Pythagoras.
Mhm.
The True City's guard has potential work clearing out a stronghold to the east. Highly dangerous. Just, yeah, pays well, but. No one's come back alive.
Like
I don't know.
Yeah, exactly. Does sound like our kind of thing. What do you guys think? Is everybody here now?
Yeah.
What do you guys think?
Clearing an area out of east of what?
I roll out the map and I point out Fellhorn. Is this the place they're talking about?
Closer to us. It's a stronghold of some kind that's been overrun by some monster army something.
This kind of sounds like a goblin problem.
It does.
I think it's a little bit more advanced than that. They've sent multiple parties.
I think we could handle it.
If we took all the villagers and had them all armed, maybe.
At least then there'll be no one left to go to Bree'ek.
If we want to get involved in the war, that's one way to totally get involved. Mm-hmm. I'm still partial to going back to Bree'ek to kill the goblins, personally.
Yeah, I still want to do that a little more. What about you guys?
I think so. I mean, worst case scenario, we come back on one of our other visits, and if the contract hasn't been fulfilled, we know we can always head east.
Yeah, true.
I like that.
I don't really want to be in the middle of a war either.
Yeah.
Other than that, the guardsman's been taken care of.
Sorry, what was that?
Do we know what this war is about exactly? Did we find out before I came along?
No, we. All I know is about the nobles that are warring in the city right now. I don't know if that has anything to do with it. But...
I don't think we found out specifically. I thought it was just a war of aggression from one to the other, really.
It was
pretty much one of the information you guys had found previously was it's kind of one of those feuds that have been going on so long, everybody's forgotten why they still need each other. It's just been back and forth for as long as it is, and all it takes is for one noble in Fellhorn and one noble in
Aredell,
thank you, to decide that they don't like each other when they go for, you know, an afternoon game of something. You know what I mean? And then they try to murder each other and get hundreds killed in the process.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, like, pretty much every other
one. Yeah, I'd be game to go back up to Bree'ek, take care of some little green dudes, try and take some revenge for my knee in the back of my head.
All right. Okay. So, in that case, is there anything else you guys, so when are you planning on departing and that sort of thing?
I figure we could just go back with... Are they going back to Bree'ek? The villagers? Yeah, might as well just go back with them when they leave.
Alright. I say we get, like a cart or a wagon, like a second one, and just fill it full of grain.
Mm-hmm.
Or something,
mm-hmm.
Yeah. Right? So that we kind of have that extra surplus of food.
Yeah.
And then that'll hopefully tide them over between that and when they can get timber either down or to the tower or wherever they need to send timber to get more trade.
All right. So as you're sitting discussing everything, you see this old kind of shaky, as the best description, looking man walking around this tavern and poking people on the shoulder. And you see him, like, waving his hands. And then generally most, like, the mercenary types just go, no, or some of you push him away. And he stumbles back and looks around. And then approaches another group of people and talks to them and waves his hands. And then they're like... Until he eventually makes his way towards all of you. He says, ah, hello. You folks look like you can handle yourselves. My... Well, do I have a proposition for you? Am I glad you asked? You see, there's been some strange things happening lately. I'm sure you've heard all about them. And, well,
I, as I'm sure you can tell, was once a very rich man. So rich, in fact, that I held a wonderful fort, and it was off in the forest.
What the hell is going on right now? Who is this guy?
Just interrupts all conversations, just starts giving you this like very respected
speech. I'll just kind of try and like shoulder in and like block him off.
He like puts his arm up on your shoulder, just like just talking to your like inches from your face. Yes. And then one day things started going awry in the forest, and things came and took my home from me. My wonderful, wonderful place where I lived. Please, I'm going adventuring group to adventuring group seeking help. And everyone else is just too weak and pleb-like to assist me. And I'm wondering if you fine, brave people would be willing to take on the task. No one else will. I will assure you, you'll get paid quite well and you get all the fame you can ask for.
Brushes off his disgusting looking robe.
Is this really happening? I'd like to roll an insight.
Roll an insight check to see if this guy is crazy. He sounds pretty crazy.
All right. So I just need bus fare.
While everyone's doing insight, I'll ask him where.
Okay.
Where is this magical keep of mighty wealth?
It's off to the west in the forest. Yep.
Of course it is.
Is he wasted? Like, does he seem drunk? Or
no,
can I,
drunk,
can I smell it off of
no,
him?
No, no smell, no liquor. Yeah.
Just straight
is
up.
Is it also called Umber Mill?
You're very funny. No! Umber Mill's a town! It's kind of in that area, though. You know the place. You know your geography well.
I think you're related to a woman I know there once. Do you have any relatives that live in that forest?
I don't think so. No one I know. No. I don't know anyone. I live alone. I've always been alone. For so long. And my home was taken from me.
He starts like breaking down and crying and trying to put on a show. Okay, what did you guys get for your insight checks?
10 and I got 18. Okay. I just want to see if he's like kind of desperate or like he's trying to fucking lie to us about this.
Okay, so Pai, yeah, you have a little more insight in the situation. What you're gathering from this is he's definitely putting on a bit of a show. And he definitely doesn't look like anyone that was ever rich or noble at any given point. But he seems to be pretty truthful about the fact he wants you to go into some place and do something there. Like, he's very precise with where he's staying is located, if you guys pry anymore. And he seems pretty honest about that. But his true intentions around it are somewhat clouded.
So what do you say? I will pay you very well.
You, no offense, but you don't look like you have money.
Oh. Well, no. Not on me. It's all in the keep. They took it because I have money. If you go there, I'll give you a substantial portion of all my wealth that still resides there.
How do you know it's still
there? Wouldn't they have spent it by now?
No. They can't find where it's hidden. I've hidden it so well.
Why did they take your keep?
I don't know, because it's a very fine keep.
Who took your keep?
Well, several people tried. The ones that succeeded were these strange creatures. Had noses like pigs and tusks jutting from their mouth and large ears and oh, the stench! Oh, I can still taste and smell it now.
Not goats.
Is there anything about this guy that kind of stands out besides him like wiping himself and being an old man?
He really wants you to go. He like really wants you to go to this place. And every time he talks about his possessions in the place, he's almost talking about them as if he like he really wants them back. Like he's, oh yeah, and then there's this. I have gold, and I bet you I have jewels as well. Yes, I probably do.
I've never seen them, but I'm sure they're there.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
An old man who's traveled all this way just to seek help of brave individuals such as yourselves.
Where is the keep?
To the west in the forest. Here, do you have a map? You are adventurers. You must have a map.
Yeah, I'll show him the map. You mean this goddamn godforsaken forest?
Yes! That's my home. So he just puts his finger down, right in kind of the dead center of the, sorry, I have a black and white version of it printed here, but like right there. So kind of dead center of this forest. And he says,
going there anyway.
Yes, it's quite well hidden. Not so many people know there.
It's west of the ruined tower.
What ruined tower? I didn't wreck any towers.
That looks like it's northwest, doesn't it?
It's still west. I wasn't lying.
No, no, but said something, you know, if we do head north, then we might be able to.
I'll tell you what. I will ensure you will travel there much quicker. He closes his eyes. He starts doing this.
What?
I'm gonna gesture for us to, like, leave.
I roll like stealth. I'm totally rolling stealth.
Okay. Is anyone else gonna try and sneak away while he's
Yeah, totally.
This? Yeah, I'm gonna stealth too.
Yeah, let's do it.
One.
I got 24.
Apparently, Mabel, like, trips over the table.
Oh, just get a one as well.
I've been here drinking for like the last 5 hours.
I don't know if the rest of your rolls really matter. You guys try and get away. Maple gets on her chair. The chair like topples over, hits on her chair. The chair that Ailey's was sitting in. And while he gets up, he trips over it and falls on her. The table and the drink falls over.
Run, guys! Run!
The old man just opens his eyes as you're running.
No! I prepare to slam the door in his face.
Okay, yeah. You guys shut the door. And you hear him, like, trying to open it desperately. He can't for some reason. And then after you're a few, like, running down the road, you see him in the door of the inn. He says, "No! I'll make you all rich! I'll make you rich!" As you see, you may not have noticed, but he's completely barefoot as well. Yeah. Anyways.
Wow.
At least we know where to go.
Spell really worked.
I'll tell Pythagoras to maybe jot that down on the map.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Not that we trust him, but it's something that we could check out.
Yeah, it's on the way. Sort of.
Well, from Bree'ek, right, you just take little side trips, right? Head in for a few days, come back. Right?
Yep. All right, is there anything else you guys would like to accomplish in town? I know you said you wanted to purchase a cart, but anything else they'd take care of before you head back to Bree'ek?
I bought some rations for myself and she.
Okay.
Yes, I need some rations as well.
I'm doing rations. I would buy myself a second water skin.
I had a thought, Antimaeus. I was thinking...
I like where this is going.
We could hire a cart. It's just me and Antimaeus, like, kind of whispering to each other. We could get a cart, a carriage. And maybe the driver disappears somehow? And we end up owning a carriage?
accidentally? I would never condone anything like this.
Are you talking in town?
Yeah. I know, it's just it's a matter of perspective, really, I mean, so.
I do know a couple guards that might let us through the gates.
You think you could swing something like that? Then we'd have our own carriage.
How much is a carriage, anyway?
It's like 3 copper per mile.
No, but can you buy one?
Yeah, you can buy one for 100 gold.
It's like a covered carriage, right? Ooh. Like, so you can get out of the elements?
Yeah.
A tiny home on wheels.
Alex, what do I need to roll to know if that's a thing here in Aredell? Or is that kind of like a lords and nobles only?
Typically lords and nobles only kind of stuff.
I'll tell Pythagoras, if we attempt this, we might be leaving on worse circumstances than last time we left.
I do like the city. I like the coward's tear.
I could talk to a guy tonight before we get settled and see if there's any contacts for potential available cart.
Make it happen, accountant.
I'll go to a contact in a bar or something and send a message that see if there's any kind of like soft target for something like that. Like talk to the guild or go wherever. Specifically, if there's any Black Sun carts, that would be ideal.
Yeah, there you go.
Yep. In fact, they can do you one better. The guild really has no need for carts because they don't travel during the day, but they definitely just murdered a whole bunch of Black Sun guys that were carrying some valuable goods. They'll strip give you the cart. They're cool. Keeping the horses, though, so you need to supply the horses for it.
That's okay. I already have two. Okay. Do they know anything about a carriage?
That you'd have to requisition for yourself. You're interfering with nobles at that point, which at this point is too risky for the guild.
We haven't decided. We're staying undecided.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
They don't want to give the impression they've picked someone.
I'll let them know, just like passing message that, you know, I'm heading off to Bree'ek and that we have a potential acolyte that I'm working with.
Okay.
Something like that.
All right.
So.
They respond and obviously this is a note exchange. They say, okay, well, you know what to do. Make sure that they go through the necessary rigors and bring them back when you think they're ready.
Perfect.
And they say in the thing, the cart will be delivered tomorrow.
Sorry?
They say the cart will be delivered tomorrow.
Perfect. Hopefully no dead people in it. But...
okay. The next day comes, I'm assuming, unless there's anything else you can do during this day.
I think that was it for me. Yeah, like I said, rations and a water skin, that's all I had.
Okay, alright. Okay, so the next day comes, cart is miraculously dropped off. The innkeep, when you come downstairs, points out to you guys. So... this was left under your name, I believe. And he points to Pythagoras. Says, I only know that because they were singing songs about you.
What was left?
A cart.
Huh.
Under your name.
Those bard guys?
No, someone else. They wouldn't tell me who they were.
What did they look like?
Nothing really. They wore a lot of leather? They kept their faces hidden. They passed me a note, and they left. The note just says, for Pythagoras.
Oh. Cool. Well, thank you. Mm-hmm. I'm assuming that's the guild, Antimaeus. Oh, you
can't hear you, Jordan.
Oh, I'll just wink at you.
The really like obvious like.
Yeah. Achoo.
So I'm assuming the carriage didn't work out then. Oh well.
Okay. So you guys,
if that's the best you can do.
You guys seat up your horses to the carriage?
Yeah.
Or to the cart, sorry, not the carriage.
Yeah, so we got like the one draft horse pulling the one, and then we'll have the other two pulling.
Okay.
The other one we just got, I guess.
All right.
And then all the goats and chickens. And...
Make sure you feed Necromancer.
Yeah. I'm going to ride Necromancer.
Hey, yeah, he's Necromancer dead.
Starts licking the burlap bags that contain the grain.
Onward, Necromancer! Necromancer! Onward! Damn it! Necromancer!
He doesn't stop. He got more forceful, and then he looks at you and just says...
Attaboy.
He's walking. Alright. It doesn't seem like, no matter how much you beat this thing, it doesn't get any thicker. It's still like skin and bones.
That's how I want it. Yes, character.
Alright, so you guys depart. Aredell then, I'm assuming, heading towards Bree'ek.
Yep.
Okay. Outside, you're greeted by John Tane, who brought the people outside to camp for the night. He said he asked around at a few of the inns and was like, that was just way too expensive, so we just stayed out here for the night. It wasn't too bad. I was able to get some blankets and stuff from kind people, so there was, you know, we stayed warm, we huddled, lit a fire or two.
You'll be home soon.
Alright, yeah, okay. I see you acquired another cart. It's probably a good thing.
Yeah. How much would the grain cost, Alex, if we got a bunch of grain? I don't know.
5 copper per day, per person, I guess, or per beast, whatever, however you want to measure that. So
that's as much as we can carry.
Yeah. Really? How much can we plow into that thing?
Into the cart? We could probably get a month's worth into a cart.
So, like,
perfect.
A couple gold pieces.
Unless, yeah. What could you carry more? Like, what if.
Sad frames. Like, fill it up.
What if we were able to get actual flour instead of the actual grain, like the actual refined stuff? You can carry more of it.
Sure, I don't know. What's that cost you?
A lot more.
Like, a lot. A lot more.
Sacks. Oh,
that's an actual trade good.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. In so you guys can definitely find that if you wish, but it's a lot more expensive.
Oh, okay. I knew it would be more expensive because it's already been refined and whatnot. Yeah. But
yeah, for the same amount, you're looking at like 30 or 40 gold pieces for a month's worth.
Right.
Do we want to do that? Just everyone pitch in some money and then just be done with it?
Yeah. Sure.
And maybe in exchange, that I mean, so the town can give us a building in town for like permanent, and we own it. And...
The town can make Pythagoras a lord, and then they can pay him taxes.
I think that is very reasonable.
Well, because wouldn't there be a lot of plenty of traffic going through, like north to south through Bree'ek?
Everything he's done for them, it's the least they could do.
Once we're done, it'll be a booming city. Don't you worry. So if just everyone just kicks in 5 gold.
Sure.
Yeah, absolutely.
Then I think we'd cover it.
Because you can carry more flour, and it takes up less room, and they don't have to do the work when they get
there. We'll get a tarp so Alex can't turn it into anything semi-solid.
Yeah, you get like canvas or something, yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, when it rains and snows, it doesn't become a big like gelatinous mass.
Quickly bake bread.
Hurry! Make bread with haste.
Pancakes.
Okay. Yeah, pancakes. Okay, so you guys then are departing, I assume.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, no. Before we leave, we should talk to John Tane and some of the other villagers to find out if they want to pursue the contract with Obi.
No. I veto that. Pythagoras.
No, I just want to make I just want to make them aware of that. That's all. And then
he'll let you guys know if you guys want to front that cost. That's fine, but I don't have a gold piece to my name, so you guys have to do that for us.
For future trade, that's all I'm suggesting here. That's your guys' call. I'm just letting you know. And we did look into the other guy. He just had enough work here that he never had to leave to go up north to go help you guys out. So he says he might be back after the winter, but you're probably best off finding trade with someone else.
Yeah, well, we'll send people north to Aeliath once we have lumber again. We do really appreciate everything you guys are doing, so thank you.
Glad we can help, and maybe, hopefully, we can make Bree'ek our base of operations.
And with, I don't see why not.
And you should name Pythagoras Lord.
And with that, I fall asleep with my eyes open.
He says, we've never really had a lord before.
Well, that's why you need one.
Yeah, as Pythagoras is now sleeping, I will work with Maple on convincing John Tane that
I fully endorse
a central government that has support of highly armed people will be good for the town.
And I mean look, he already has a holiday there, so I mean he's helping out the people.
Can you give me a charisma check, each of you? Or persuasion.
I don't have persuasion, so I have a 20 though. Not a natural. Oh, no, I don't have persuasion. Dang it. 20.
10.
Alright.
So why don't you just riding... intimidate?
Because I don't think that's any better. Yeah, no better.
sorry, as you journey towards Bree'ek, you guys are working on him and trying to get him to.
I'll explain the importance of a mayor position underneath the Lord when the Lord is away and the mayor has to take care of the people and he's the people's representative, but the Lord has to look out for the greater good and
so, make sure you people don't go hungry again.
Let me understand, like if we ever have issues like we were having recently, it falls to him to make sure that we're taken care of?
Yes.
And this is what we're doing. Idea. We're fulfilling those duties already.
This is a great deal. In fact, you know, most of us would not even be alive without his help. So, yeah, I mean, if he's willing to guarantee us food and safety, then I mean, I don't see why not.
And there will be a menial fee, you know, some of the trade goods or, you know, obviously he has to support that structure, right?
Well, of course. And I'm sure he would never want to harm the situation of the village. So I'm sure he'll be fair. Yeah, sure. We'll name Pythagoras our lord.
Perfect. Agreed.
Cool. I mean,
we'll make it official when we get back.
Can't wait to find out about this.
So, anything you guys like to accomplish on your journey to Bree'ek?
I'd like to do more hunting along the way and kind of like the idea we were doing when we went there with the rations and all that. I do think we should still kind of ration a little bit. Yeah.
All right. Can everybody that's hunting give me a survival check with an advantage?
Oh. One. Because of disadvantage. Oh, with advantage? Oh, I thought you said with disadvantage. No. I was like, damn it. Well, never mind. Whoa, that's much better.
I got 15.
11.
Nice.
Okay. God, I rolled 20.
20?
I rolled a 20 plus 4.
All right. For the full 10 days, you guys managed to feed everybody half of what they would have normally had to take out of rations. So only 50% of it is used.
Hmm. Decent.
Do you want to just actually start tracking that?
You can just take a bulk thing off of it. That'll be for the whole travel to Bree'ek.
Okay.
And otherwise, the trip to Bree'ek is fairly uneventful this time, which is nice.
There's no one on the side of the road waiting for a shipment of weapons.
Not today. however.
Out of curiosity, is Bryson still with us?
Brisa? Yeah.
He's going to get used to it. I'm never going to get his name right.
Okay. Yeah, he's still there. He's talking less these days. He still, you know, talks, but not
what,
quite
what a, okay, and now my next question is, did that other guy come with us?
The guy with the stomach wound?
Yeah.
I guess you're going to drop him off in an alley? That's what I assumed
you
did.
Oh, I thought he was just with us on the cart the majority of the time. I don't know.
I was joking. I was like, just throw him into the back.
That's legitimately what I
thought we did that.
You know what?
I would have took him to an infirmary and just left him there.
Regardless, if you guys hadn't have dealt with him by the time you went to the inn, the tavern there, he would have gotten up and left. So if you guys hadn't dealt with him by then, which it sounds like you hadn't, he wasn't there when he got back.
We probably should have taken him out.
Oops.
Yeah, everyone's gonna know who we are now.
They already knew who we were.
So, as you approach Bree'ek, you guys are hunting and scouting forward a little bit more. You get close to the town, everything's gone really, really well. Until you arrive in here. From several voices in the village.
Oh, surprise, surprise.
I'm gonna pull up my bow already.
Yeah, I'm pulling up the crossbow.
Pull up the short spear.
I'm just ready to go. The first little green fucker that walks in front of me.
All right.
One, as you're just kind of sitting there waiting, one does end up coming out of the village. Doesn't seem to notice you guys at all. And it's just kind of like, has something in his hand. Scratches his little head.
Is he the only one we see?
Yeah, so far. Yeah. You still hear voices from in the village, but he's the only one you see. And then he kind of like lets out this little yawn. And then sits there with a little spear. And gradually opens his eyes down the road and sees you standing
Clink.
There. Yeah.
I'm gonna let go.
All right. Surprise!
That's a 19.
That's it.
No!
And I'll hit him for 8.
Standing there, eyes go wide. Arrow right into one of the set of wide eyes. And just falls to the ground with this kind of splat, just silently. And you still hear it inside.
I'll double dash to the building side. Okay. And peer around.
I'm wondering if, someone should try to, sneak in, or should we stay and protect the village?
The villagers.
They should be able to protect
some of them might still have some weapons on them, the few of them there. They should stay all together here at the carts, protect the carts. For them.
Yeah.
We can go in and clear the city.
Yeah.
And see if the other two are still alive.
So I'm going to just motion to Maple, kind of like, hey, let's sneak around. Back that like sneak, try to flank.
Sneak around.
Sneak.
Back.
Sneak.
Really? We're going that route.
I don't know, but or
because my tavern scene went so well. Okay.
So Antimaeus, as you sneak up to one of the building sides and look into the center of the village, you see 8 little green guys standing there with various weapons. One of them is cooking a big thing on a rotisserie. That unfortunately appears to be one of the villagers. And a couple of them are like, oh! He's like,
these are too cute to kill.
I'll turn to the group and, like, direct them to, like, go around.
Okay.
but I'll stay there and keep watch and like drag the dead goblin out of sight.
All right. So the rest of you guys are gonna go around.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay, give me stealth checks, please. And if you don't have stealth, next.
Maybe they can be reasoned with.
And I'll tell the villagers before we run off to stay here.
One.
Yeah. 20.
I got a 6.
You guys 18. Suck. Oh, right, yeah!
The two barbarians.
The big
one. Yeah. We're better in the snow than you guys.
Okay, light. We're used to sneaking in the snow. Moose are a lot more skittish this time of year.
Xena?
No, not natural.
I'm just whistling that tune I heard in the tavern. Pythagoras.
So you guys are sneaking up to... You successfully get around the village without being seen. You're starting to sneak up closer to the village square. And Pythagoras, your shin bumps something. And you see this frozen hand. And you notice that like you just busted like a couple fingers off of it. And you just see this kind of face popping through the snow. Like, but it's also frozen. It looks like one of the undead creatures that you guys killed here a long time ago that just didn't get cleaned up. But unfortunately, the snap, you, without really meaning to, let out a, oh, God! The rotisserie slowly comes to stop. And it goes, and you guys have a round of surprise. Do whatever you'd like to these guys.
Do whatever we want? So you do, what would we want to do other than kill them?
I don't know. Cook them, eat them, put them in a stew.
Well, if we're close enough, I want to run in and attack one with my spear.
Oh yeah, you can run and attack
one. Oh, hell yeah.
No
problem. And I'll, yeah.
How many of them are there?
Just 16 8. Hit.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Could I charge in and do my thunder wave before these guys do their thing so I don't hurt them?
Sure. Yeah, sure.
You'll spoil, but you might spoil the meat. This.
Smells good.
So yeah, I'll just run right into the center of them. They gotta make a 12 con save.
I can't imagine they have much for con.
Okay, alright, roll up the damage.
Oh, that's not bad. 6 damage.
What does your Thunder Wave look like?
I always activate it by like slamming the hilt of my rapier into my shield, so it's just like BOOM! And then it just wave comes out.
So these guys are scrambling to get their weapons, and Pythagoras runs in, Maple beside him, Almagar beside him. Are you knocking an arrow or anything else?
I'm knocking an arrow. I was going to send him flying.
All right, are you running into Antimaeus or just waiting?
Knowing that this is going to happen somehow, I will not be as fast as I normally am.
Okay. Pythagoras, you run in first. Boom! And this resounding comes from your shield. And 6 of the 8 goblins burst in various parts of the combat. One's head just the other one flies back into a house. It's pale on a broken board. Oh, another one just falls down, but you hear his whole chest crumple in on itself. And 2 still fall to the ground, very, very injured. And they just look up with like little hands, trying to still grab their spears. Ah! Ikta! Then they drop their weapons and their hands are in the air.
Yeah,
to hara!
You had a 16 hit?
Yep.
Six damage.
curb stomp.
Guys, honestly. Just.
And I rolled an 18 to hit.
Oh yeah, to hit
the last guy.
Yep.
Oh, I guess I should roll damage because you know. Oh. 5 damage.
Two-handed axe comes down, and just obliterates.
Ah, barbarians.
And there's 8 dead goblins.
Oh, I was going to say, you're going to try to talk
That's
to them?
That's what I thought our first combat with goblins was. Not the other way around.
Fucking combat with
goblins was supposed to go like.
Not hoping the wolves will save us.
All right. So, with that, a few of the villagers, like, crept forward to see what was going on.
And they just I'll stop them.
Okay.
I'll be like, back away. Back okay, away.
They're like, oh, but, okay.
They got the cards.
Okay, okay. And they move back to the cart.
Lord Pythagoras' orders.
I'm just going to do a quick sweep, like, try to, you know, look in a few buildings. I don't want to have any surprises, you know.
Sure.
Some goblin.
Try to take an arrow out of the guy's eyeball.
Okay.
Does it come out? Maybe.
Yep.
Cool. Cool. Wipe it on his corpse. A little bit. But...
Yeah. Anyways. Yeah. So you check the buildings. Give me perception.
I'll yell for she to get that body down before the villagers see it.
Okay. All right, she runs up and does that.
20 for perception.
Okay.
Not natural, though.
Okay. You look around there, Almagar. You're pretty confident that there's nobody hiding these buildings. It looks like all of them were out there. What really leads you on to this is they have a little camp. It looks like they're actually sleeping outside for the most part. You know, stinky human and everything else. And it looks like there's nothing left of these guys.
Okay, I'll just give the all clear then.
Okay.
While everyone's doing that, I want to follow their tracks to see if it heads the same way where we had our encounter previous, where the guys ran away on us, since we had that one that ran away. I want to see if he's just kind of going in that same direction.
Okay. All right, give me a survival check there, Maple. She cuts into the body and struggles to lift it up on her shoulder, but does so and kind of takes it off and tosses it in the snow and then just piles snow up on top of it.
8.
Okay. Unfortunately, these little bastards have trudged their way around the village quite a bit, so there's actually tracks leading both into the forest to the east and to the west. You're not sure which ones are the freshest. All right. Anything else you guys would like to do in this village for the immediate?
I guess look for survivors.
Yeah, if there are any, we know there's one down.
Yeah. And yeah, you quickly find the other one. Looks like they were killed in their home. They're just up against a wall, spear still stuck in their gut.
I told them. Should have came.
I'll let the villagers in.
Okay. Alright, the villagers come in, they're like, they look at the desiccated bodies of the goblins and just, yay!
Pythagoras!
Pythagoras!
Lord Pythagoras!
Yes.
Yes.
No, I am, and I'm going to cast Thaumaturgy, and okay. Just to remind you how it works, I can cast 3 different effects. So the first one, I'm going to have my voice be 3 times louder.
Okay.
And the second one, I'm going to cause harmless tremors in the ground, so that it's just going to shake a little bit.
All right.
And then the third one is I can create sounds about 30 feet away or something like that. And it's going to be the sound of thunder way off in the distance. And I'm Pythagoras, the Thunder Champion!
Even Almagar is gonna be like.
Everybody just goes silent and wide-eyed. And they all kind of look to John Tane to see his reaction. And he says, "Hail Lord Pythagoras, the Thunder Champion!" Hand up in the air. And the then Thunderbolt they all come out. "Hail Lord Pythagoras!" Yes, and they continue to cheer this for many moments, and they all cheer and clap and rejoice.
Antimaeus will kneel and hint at others to do so.
If Antimaeus does, I'll totally
I'll take a knee.
You guys manipulate these poor people.
I'm gonna get into it. I'll strike a pose.
So everyone takes Maple. Do you take a knee to Pythagoras?
No. I'll actually grab my spear and I'll do like a salute, like a stance, and I'll just kind of stand there like a soldier,
like his royal guard.
Yeah, I'm his Valkyrie.
And you know, the rest are groveling on the ground.
John Tane kind of looks around and starts nodding to people, and he like gets down on a knee, and then everybody gets down on their knee, and they're calling out, "Hail Lord Pythagoras!
I'll yell, "Long live the defender," and then I'll pull my sword and put it up in the air.
Long live the defender! Long live
the I'll strike and a pose and you'll hear the thunder again.
Alright. This chant continues on for quite some time. And I think that's where we'll end it for.
By now, like, there's people up in the White Tower going, "What the fuck is going on?" That little fucker.
What the fuck did you say about magic?
Send all the people.